And our Thursday night football brings us to M&T Bank Stadium in Baltimore. And our matchup at the AFC North, the Cleveland Browns and the hometown Baltimore Ravens. And as I'm sure all of you know by now, the regular officials are back. This the scene an hour ago as they came out of the tunnel to a standing ovation. And so Gene Steratore and his group with 70 years of experience, you can see Ray Lewis. The players are happy. The officials are back. The officials are happy they're back. We're happy they're back.
Oh, yeah.
Welcome, everybody. Brad Nessler with Mike Mayock. So what effect does it have on the game tonight, partner?
I thought John Harbaugh said it best yesterday. He said the gray area had gotten so large for the players, they no longer knew what was a foul. So I think there's a comfort level tonight, Brad. I think the players know. I think the coaches know. And we can all get back to concentrating on football.
Well, it's never as black and white as their uniforms, but that gray area got a little bit smaller. Yeah. Let's talk about Baltimore. Coming off a big win over the Patriots on Sunday night, Joe Flacco was at his best.
Hey, they really trust this guy. 62% of their offense now is throwing the football. Look for two things tonight. Number one, their no-huddle offense is going to go at NASCAR speed. They're going to try and get this thing rolling and knock these guys right out of the building. Number two, look for 6 to 8 deep shots. I think Baltimore might be the best vertical team in the league.
All right, for the Cleveland Browns, they need their rookie backfield to perform well, especially at the tailback spot.
Formula has to be run the football, play great defense, play great special teams. Rookie tailback Trent Richardson a couple of weeks ago against Cincinnati, 23 touches, 145 yards, 2 touchdowns. Last week against Buffalo, they got away from that. They got behind. They left the running game out, and Brandon Weeden was highly ineffectual.
Pat Shurmur in his second season as the head coach of the Browns. And on the other side, just turning 50 years old a few days ago, John Harbaugh. 4 straight years, the first 4 years, all playoff appearances. They want more than just the playoffs this year. Tonight's game's available in HD and Spanish on your SAP channel. Tucker to kick. This one won't be returned. So Brandon Weeden and the Browns will come out to start things at the 20-yard line. There's Weeden, his numbers on this early season so far. And the group in front of him. Joe Thomas, a Pro Bowler each of his 5 seasons with Pinkston, Mack, Avalo, and Schwartz. And the backs and receivers, Richardson, Benjamin, both rookies starting. Greg Little, Ben Watson, the tight end. 2 tight ends, Jordan Cameron as well. So basically 3 rookies in that starting skill spots tonight. And here's the guy we just talked about. And a great start for Trent Richardson as he goes out for 7 yards on the first snap of the ball game. Defensively for the Ravens. Not one of the best in the business. The linebacking core, I'm pretty sure you know, Ray Lewis. And on the back end, Ed Reed still at the top of his game in that secondary for the Ravens. First pass, slant, complete. And it's to Greg Little. So a good start, a good run, and then a nice quick pass.
Yeah, and you know, when you get a single high safety, Brad, and you're going to put 8 in the box to stop the run game, Brandon Weeden's got to make those kind of throws. His wide receiver 1 outside, put it right on him for a first down.
They'll go with a 3 wide receiver set here now that they moved it out to the 34-yard line. Weeden in the shotgun. Going to roll to his right. Fires on the run and in and out of the hand. Should have been caught by Little. Lardarius Webb was the man covering for Baltimore.
Greg Little led the entire NFL in drops a year ago. Had a drop I saw on tape last week. Big, good-looking kid, but no consistency.
11 drop passes for the Browns through week 3, and that's more than anybody else has had. Richardson trying to bounce it outside, but LRB won't let him. Only a 3-yard gain on the play. Bring up 3rd down and long. The Ravens, only 7 points in the opening drive in the last 27 games. They haven't allowed a point yet this year on an opponent's opening drive.
And you can hear how loud it's getting in this building. Ravens, one of the best home teams in football. And for a rookie quarterback on 3rd down, There's a lot of pressure on you.
And here they come. Weeden gets rid of it in a hurry. Almost picked off. And that was Paul Kruger, the outside linebacker. Obanaya was the intended receiver. So one first down for the Browns. Now they'll have to give it up.
Yeah, the ball's got to come out more quickly than that. Weeden's got to get it to the outside. Bang, he undercuts the route, almost intercepts it. That's a rookie quarterback in the NFL, and he pays the price for letting the ball go late.
Reggie Hodges will punt. You look behind him, and Jacoby Jones is on the other end, a guy that's got three career punt return touchdowns. And this one will go out of bounds before he can get a play on it. So the Ravens will have their first shot on offense with Joe Flacco and company here on their home field when we come back in a minute. The Ravens will work from their own 30-yard line. And he's had an excellent career, perfect 8-0 against Cleveland. Two tight ends and Pitta and Dixon in there, and Ray Rice, the lone setback. Play action to Rice, and a deep ball right off the bat. Incomplete. Torrey Smith went one way, the ball went the other.
Yeah, Usama Young, the safety, came on a blitz off the edge and disrupted the timing of the route. Flacco just had to get rid of the football.
Torrey Smith, who had two touchdown catches a week ago in that victory, I shouldn't say a week ago, Sunday night
right,
over the Patriots. So second down at 10. And now the fullback, Vontae Leach, in front of Ray Rice.
Alaska, 10.
On second down and 10, it'll be a draw to Rice, a stiff arm.
Oh boy.
Cuts outside, and he's going to have a first down. 10 yards, and he flattened Craig Robertson en route.
The lead back, Vontae Leach, had nobody at all to even block. Look at this thing open up. Ramon Harewood did a great job. The stiff arm by Rice is spectacular. And we talked before in our pregame show about how he finishes and how physical and tough he is. That's a great example.
First down from the 40. Play action. Flacco steps up, comes back to the near side of Leach, and he made a shoestring catch. And he's wrestled down by Maiva. But he got 7 yards. And they have a first flag of the first quarter.
They going to boom him, Ness? What do you think?
We'll find out.
Prior to the pass, illegal contact, defense.
Nope, they're going to cheer that one. Sheldon Brown picks up the penalty, and it'll be first down yardage.
Sheldon Brown's been in this league 11 years. I think his best football was with the Philadelphia Eagles several years ago. He can still play zone, but when they jump into man-to-man, he can be a liability, and I expect to see Flacco go after him all night long.
So a free first down at the 45-yard line.
Yeah, Alaska, yeah.
Three wide out set for Joe Flacco.
Yeah.
See if he takes another shot downfield. He will on the sideline. Incomplete. A little bit of contact back there with Buster Screen. And we'll bring up second down and 10 as we take a look at the offense. Matt Burke, still a tough one in there. His 15th year. Backs and receivers. Bolden and Smith, the wide receivers, with Jacoby Jones and Pitta, the tight end. Ray Rice, obviously, the tailback. Flacco in the gun. Wants to throw a middle screen. Ray Rice, couple of blockers in front. Across the 50, down to the 47-yard line, a pickup of 8. Defensively for the Browns, they've got a rookie in their front wall, playing very well in Billy Winn. Linebackers leader there, DeQuell Jackson, just celebrated his 29th birthday yesterday. And in the back end, Patterson, the guy that made the tackle on that last carry on the screen pass by Rice. Third down and 2. Ray Rice dancing in the hole, flags fly in. Let's see if we have a holding call, and then we might have our first chorus of boos from the hometown fans.
Yeah, that play was disrupted by Frosty Rucker. Michael Orr got beat inside, which immediately will nullify that play.
Let's listen into the call from Gene Steratore and the reaction from the folks.
Nine, holding, offense, number 74, penalty is declined, fourth down.
As soon as he got beaten, as he reached out, let you hear the noise?
Just a little bit.
Right here, he's going to get beat across his face and then reach out with that right arm and grab. That's an easy call. And I think the hometown fans are taking a little easy right now.
Yeah,
huh?
Yet finally, they've got their regulars back so they can boo those guys.
A little papal dispensation for the first quarter.
Exactly.
We're happy you guys are back here.
It only took 3.5 minutes for the first chorus of boos. Cook to kick. Joshua Cribbs lets it go, bounces at the four, it'll make it to the end zone. 47-yard punt, no return. When we return, Browns will have their second shot on offense. We talked about what a great game Torrey Smith had Sunday, 24 hours after the death of his brother.
I want to just thank all y'all for y'all support, man. It's new territory for me.
Got 60 brothers in here, baby.
You know, a loss like this, man, and, you know, if it wasn't for y'all, I don't think I would have even been here today. You know, it's just tough, man. I appreciate all the support. You know, y'all really made me feel better, and, you know, it's going to make this fight a whole lot easier, you know, a lot easier to get over with, man. I just appreciate y'all. I love all y'all, coaches, players, everyone, man, and just thank you.
Yes. Love you, man.
Joe Flacco said to us yesterday, even if he hadn't played, just the fact that he was around us would help. He not only played, he starred.
That video and audio was powerful stuff, and yeah. It just kind of reinforces the extended football family and how important it is in all their lives.
Second offensive series for the Browns. Quick throw out to Cribbs. Can't break the tackle out there, though, of Webb.
Yeah.
He stays with it along with McClellan.
You know, McClellan and Webb, two young guys. Webb has gotten better and better. Third-round pick from a small school, Nichols State. They put him on the slot in third down. He tackles. He blitzes. I think he's one of the finest young corners in the game.
On second and eight, Richardson runs into his own lineman, then runs into a wall of Ravens. A pickup of three as we check in third member of our team, Alex Flanagan. Alex?
Hey, Brattle, I think maybe for the first time in NFL history, the officials were welcomed here tonight when they hit the football field with a standing ovation and a lot of applause. There's really been a great energy between the players and the officials as they've been welcomed back to this game. Gene Steratore and his crew found out last night around 11 o'clock or midnight that they would be calling this game today. I think most people really expecting a return to normalcy. Pat Shurmur told me that he expects the game to be more efficient, administered a little better, and a faster game. I think we're already seeing it, the efficiency show up here with the officials, Brad.
Absolutely. Third down and five for the Browns. Here they come after Weeden. He got rid of it and is complete to Cribbs. And he's got a first down. Boy, Weeden was under heavy pressure. He hung in there and took a shot.
Yeah, he got hit pretty good. The ball was delivered low, but Cribbs did a great job, almost like an infielder. Watch him come from the left side of your screen, crossing route. He's open, picks it up off the ground. That's a key play. That's third and six.
Yeah.
Remember last week against Buffalo, they went three and out, and all of a sudden it's a 14-0 game, and they got away from the run game. So really important for them to start stockpiling first downs.
You made a baseball analogy. Brandon Weeden, a former minor league pitcher, but I don't think he ever had guys rushing the mound when he was trying to deliver a fastball. Here's a quick throw out in the flat, and slipping and falling is Greg Little. McClellan and Cody made sure he was going nowhere. Loss on the play. 5 years in the Yankee organization, drafted 71st overall. That's before he went to Oklahoma State to be a quarterback. And there's the seasons and the one loss record. And there's a look at him in a Yankees uniform. On his rookie card, they spelled his name wrong. That might have been an omen that you needed to go to football instead of baseball.
Dude, you need to get over to football. Now's the time.
Second down and 12. Richardson, and a loss again. And our first skirmish, and the umpire gets it broken up in a hurry. And now the crowd will come to life on a third down and long.
All right, Brad, they just converted third and six. Rookie quarterback on the road, third and 12. Can't make any big mistakes. Here's the guy that had a big game last week.
Weeden fires high for the guy that you were just talking about. Incomplete. Jordan Cameron.
Cameron is a former wide receiver turned tight end from USC. They didn't know what to do with him at USC. Put some weight on. Really athletic. Does a good job working back to the football because of tight coverage by Ellerby. That's a ball that probably can be caught. And if so, you got a chance to extend the drive.
So Hodges to punt again. And Jones back deep. Kicked it a mile in the air. Jones has to fair catch it and will at the 23-yard line. The regular guys are back. Players are happy. Everybody's happy. No score so far. No score midway through the first quarter. Joe Flacco. He's perfect against the Browns. Started every game of his career, including postseason. Playoffs first 4 years. 51 wins. This is his 69th straight regular season start, second most for a quarterback to begin a career since 1950. Here's an end around to Torrey Smith. And no gain there. Nice job by the Browns to stay home. T.J. Ward made the stop.
Yeah, really good backside discipline there by the Browns on the reverse. They're just looking for touches for speed. They want to get the ball in the hands of Torrey Smith as many creative ways as they can.
Now they go back to the I backfield with Leach and Rice. Second down at 10. From the 24. Dixon, the tight end, in motion. Flags are down. Ray Rice weaves his way for about four. But again, a penalty marker on the play.
Now, Brad, you just kind of told the story of Torrey Smith a week ago and the game he had after the death of his brother. I talked to Jim Hostler, his wide receivers coach, who I've known for years, down on the field before the game, and he said, not only has the kid become a great football player, but his work ethic and love of his teammates is beyond comprehension. Apparently, when he was a rookie last year, Hostler would get text messages from him almost every night saying, Coach, are we meeting at 6 a.m. to watch tape? Coach, I want to be there at 6. Can we do it?
A little formation. Offense. Six men on the line. 5-yard penalty. Replay. Second down.
And I'm going to tell you, I was at the first mini camp that Torrey Smith was at when he was drafted in the second round from University of Maryland. You want to talk about a raw project. Exciting, but raw. And Jim Hostler's done a wonderful job teaching this young man how to run routes and catch the football.
Flacco on second down at 15. Draw play, and Cleveland all over it. Billy Wynn, the rookie defensive tackle. Rookie out of Boise State, and they've really been impressed with his play.
Yeah, sixth-round kid from Boise does a great job on Harewood. They spread it out, and I like the draw call here. Second long, but look what he does with Harewood. Basically bench presses him, stack, shed, and tackle. That's textbook right there.
And that's third and 17 for the Ravens offense. And I think we had motion on the right side.
Yeah.
Osamali, I think, the rookie
False
tackle.
Start. Offense, number 72. Foul penalty, third down.
Ravens going the wrong way.
Yeah, Kelechi Osemele, the rookie second-round pick from Iowa State. A little worried here about Jabal Sheard and his get-off. So he's trying to cheat it, and obviously the correct call. Let's go, you want to make this call, Brad? Third, whatever.
I was going to leave that one to you. Throw it to Torrey Smith. Flacco is going to throw it to Ray Rice. He's wide open in the middle, but too many Browns around in a hurry. Only got back to the 20-yard line. So the Ravens will have to give it up again.
Hey, if you're a Cleveland Browns fan, this game's going kind of the way you're hoping.
Yeah.
You've taken the home crowd largely out of it. You've made a couple of first downs. Your quarterback has his feet wet, and your defense, what people forget, Ness, Browns were number 5 in the league in points allowed a year ago. They're a pretty good day.
This guy took one to the house last year, one of the several in his career. 11 kickoff and punt returns for scores. 26. He'll get a shot at it. Whoa! Helmets out, balls out.
Oh, my.
And Josh Cribbs is probably out. Morgan Cox made the tackle. And let's hope that Cribbs is okay.
Morgan Cox is the long snapper, 46. The second hit that comes in, though, is the one that knocks the helmet off from the right-hand side. Cox was the primary. Now watch from the left here. That's Ellerbe, 59. That's the hit that got him. And remember, folks, and I know everybody's saying forearm to the helmet. He's not a defenseless player. He's a punt returner with the ball in his hands. This is not a defenseless player situation. All we really care about right now is his health.
And both teams are out there and worried about it. Cribbs, one of the better return men in the league. And as you can see, both teams huddled around the fallen Cleveland Brown. Coach Shermer out there. And
it's Ellerbe who made the hit.
Wow. So everybody saying a prayer here right now. We'll step away for a second with 5:07 remaining in the first quarter. And hopefully Joshua Cribbs will be up when we come back. While you were away, Josh Cribbs going off under his own power.
No doubt.
Meanwhile, the ball was recovered, the fumble by McClellan, so it's Raven ball. Not only did Josh take a wicked hit, he took a spike to the face, too, inadvertently, on the end of the play. And that doesn't help the cause either.
And there's the recovery, and it kind of an interesting situation as we went to commercial. Both teams had their offenses on the field. Cleveland didn't even realize, because of their concern for Cribbs, that he had fumbled and the ball was going with the Ravens.
Now Josh was even got a little bit of a smile on his face, and that's even better news. Meanwhile, the turnover gives the Ravens an opportunity from the 40-yard line.
I'd watch a deep shot here if I was Cleveland.
Three wideouts for Flacco. And whistles halt play.
The previous play is being reviewed.
I don't think there's any doubt that the ball was out, but we'll have our first official replay with the regular officials and regular replay officials here in Baltimore. That fumbled punt under review. We'll give you another look at it. Joshua Cribbs, did the helmet come off before the ball came out is what they're looking at right now. It looks like it's simultaneous to me. There goes the only thing that flew farther than the ball, quite frankly, was his helmet. And they're both coming at about the same time. Now, the ruling on the field was a fumble recovered by the Ravens. So if they had indisputable video evidence to overturn that, we'll wait and see.
Yeah, the play is immediately dead when the runner loses his helmet.
For safety purposes,
Exactly. Obviously.
And Joshua heading to the locker room. Meanwhile, Larry Nemers is our replay official. Larry, a long time on the field official.
And by the way, good job by the officials in picking that up, right?
Yep.
And that was the correct thing to do.
So this is our first review of this NFL season with the regular officials back on the job. With 5:07 remaining in the first quarter, no score here in Baltimore. You can wake up with NFL AM, the only morning show dedicated to the NFL. Tomorrow morning, Matt Cassel discusses how the Chiefs are preparing for Phillip Rivers and the Chargers. And as always, you can wake up with a first look at the latest NFL news, information, and highlights.
The ruling on the field is confirmed. Baltimore's ball, first and 10.
So the ruling on the field stands. Fumble recovered by McClellan, and it will be Ravens ball with a first down at the Cleveland 40-yard line. As Mike said about 5 minutes ago, don't be surprised if the Ravens take a shot here. But the element of surprise when they got the ball was about 10 minutes ago. We'll see if they're still thinking that way. They'll give it to Ray Rice off the left side and got a couple. Let's check in with Alex.
Well, Brad, Josh Cribbs taken to the locker room. As you watch that replay, you saw him get hit, but he also really hit his head significantly on the turf. As he came off the field, he was trying to convince people that he was okay, telling the trainers that he's all right. Of course, they took him into the locker room.
Here comes a blitz on second down. Rice in the open field, as he does so well, puts a couple of moves on to pick up the first down.
You know, I'm not sure how you're going to cover Ray Rice with your free safety, or who's really deep back in here. Ray Rice coming out, that was a linebacker, but from inside, DeQuell Jackson has no shot at making up that distance.
Again, without a huddle, Flacco down the middle, and Torrey Smith has got it inside the 20.
Really like the throw and catch. Torrey Smith is going to win to the inside. Flacco trusts him. Sheldon Brown is on his outside. Now the ball's on the wrong shoulder, but Torrey Smith makes the adjustment, and they move the chains.
Tough catch. First down inside the 18. Screen pass. Ray Rice to the 10. They pick up seven more. And again, this is what we expected from the Ravens. A no-huddle offense, moving it down the field, second down and three. And again, they'll set up at the line of scrimmage.
Yeah, a little bit more energy, Brad, since the turnover.
Six of their eight drives have resulted in touchdowns in the red zone. Ray Rice already with four catches. Flacco to the end zone. It's intercepted. And it's Craig Robertson. That one shouldn't have been thrown.
That is an unbelievable job by a sub linebacker. This is the linebacker that comes in for Kaluka Maeva in sub package situations. He's going to come all the way around. That's incredible. Run under the football, make a play. It's a scoreless tie, folks.
Mike, Joe Flacco hadn't thrown an interception in the red zone in his last 126 passes until this one.
Watch the linebacker. This is really an amazing pass to me, play by Robertson to me. He wheels under it. It's a different kind of defensive look. Man-to-man coverage. Dimitri Patterson actually does a really nice job. And Craig Robertson comes back, runs under it for his second interception of the year.
And for the Browns, their sixth of the season. The second time they've taken away one in the red zone. Weeden got a nice block. Reed was on a safety blitz. Going to go back that way to Richardson. Trent Richardson with a head of steam. And he's got 15 and more before they finally knock him out of bounds.
Yeah, he had Greg Little wide open across the middle. He checks it down to Richardson.
How good is this? He blocks Ed Reed and then gets up. Wow.
Now, look at the crossing route wide open. Now watch Greg Little come back and make a block. He's going to turn all the way around right here. Bang. That's a heck of a play. Good throw. Good check down.
That's why he's the top pick of the Browns and number three overall this year. Trent Richardson. Now they go back to him on the ground. And again, breaking tackles. Bulls his way into Ray Lewis. And he's got another first down, I believe.
Really nice job. This is just their zone scheme. This is a simple zone play.
Got a flag back at the 40-yard line.
Holding. Offense. Number 73.
Yeah.
10-yard penalty. Replay. First down.
Joe Thomas, who's made the Pro Bowl all five of his previous seasons.
Yeah, that's a shame because they did a great job in their zone scheme. Outside zone, there's the hold right at the end, holding onto the jersey of Paul Kruger. Probably didn't have to do it. But when they see the cloth being pulled, when the defender tries to get off the block, it's automatic.
First 5 years, Pro Bowls, you saw the company keeps with that.
Spot, 10 yards, replay, first down.
So they walk it back and put it down at the 28-yard line. First and 20 now for Brandon Weeden and the Browns. After they had it going, positive yardage picked up by Trent Richardson. The penalty negated most of that. Weeden straight drop. Scans the field, fires high, incompletes. Intended for Greg Little again. Not sure that was catchable, but if so, it would have been the second time Little's dropped one.
Ed Reed in coverage. I thought it might have been a catchable ball. Here's Greg Little. Ed Reed comes over, jumps the route. Ball's going to come back to Little's left. I think it's right through his hands.
Wow, it is.
Kidding me?
Yep.
Do me a favor. Catch the football.
Weeden trips, but he got the handoff to Richardson. Not much. Got three. Nada, McClellan. A whole flock of Ravens are there to meet him.
Flock of Ravens. Look at Haloti Nada. He, in my book, he's in the top 10 best players in the National Football League. He's a 340-pound dancing bear.
If I had to block him, I think I'd say Nada. He's something special. Third down and 17. Weeden, the quick throw out on the flat. Norwood's tackled immediately. Courtney Upshaw, the rookie linebacker out of Alabama, drops him.
Great reaction by the outside linebacker, Upshaw. And good pressure by the corner, Jimmy Smith. That's team defense right there.
Jacoby Jones back deep. As you look behind Reggie Hodges. Nice kick. Jones has to backpedal to the 25. And
nice
will
pass.
Not get away from the first man down. Nice job on the punt coverage, a 52-yard kick. Well, in 1995, the Cleveland Browns picked up and dramatically moved to Baltimore to become the Ravens. That move forever linked the football fortunes of these two cities. Wednesday, take an in-depth look at how it changed the course of history for two great franchises and the people who ran them. Don't miss Cleveland 95, A Football Life, Wednesday, 8 Eastern, exclusively on NFL Network. Less than a minute remaining first quarter. Brad Nessler, Mike Mayock, Alex Flanagan, and our NFL Network crew with you from Baltimore, where neither team's been able to score so far. Bernard Pierce, rookie tailback, in to give Ray Rice a breather. And he'll get the carry. And he'll get nothing out of it. Daquell Jackson, the captain and the middle linebacker, made the stop.
Yeah, they're trying to run into an eight-man front there. Numbers weren't there. That was Bernard Pierce at tailback, rookie from Temple.
Ray Rice getting a little time on the sideline. Second down at 10 for the Ravens. Both tight ends on the left side as they run the other way. Pierce maybe got two or three. Dimitri Patterson knocked him out of bounds, and that should just about do it. He was out of bounds, so that'll stop the clock.
You know, Brad, the tackle there was made by Ishmaeli Kitchen, the defensive tackle that Baltimore cut on August 31st.
They didn't make it out of bounds, so that will wind down the first quarter. A scoreless one. Hard-hitting game in Baltimore so far. You want your best player in there on third down in the 7 or 8 that's coming up, Mike.
I think the value to this kid is in his all-around great game. We know about the run game. Look at him in pass protection here. T.J. Ward, the safety coming off the edge. He gets himself between Ward and Flacco, protects his quarterback, and then, as always, in the flare checkdown game, he's had 8 touches for 42 yards. He's averaged over 20 touches per game for the last 4 years.
Came in with 1,269 touches in those 4 years that Mike's talking about. Flacco lofts it deep, and what a catch! Doss! And a first down, Ravens. 39 yards, just kind of lofted it out there and let him run under it.
Yeah, a little tight bunch. Doss and Bolden are next to each other. Remember what I said earlier about Sheldon Brown and man-to-man coverage. He does not have the speed he used to have. Tandon Doss, the second-year player out of Indiana. Ness, could you put that football out there any more beautifully?
That is throwing it in the bucket. Another completion of 25 or more for Flacco, and he's aiming for another one, and he's got another one to Torrey Smith. And it's first and goal, Ravens.
That was a cover too. Safety deep, corner shallow. You throw it in the hole. Does he get both feet down? Yes, he does. Back-to-back big plays by the Ravens and a really good diagnose on the cover too by both Flacco and Smith.
Baltimore first and goal at the Cleveland 9. Flacco 7 out of 10 so far in the ballgame. And let's see. Pitta is pointing at the Browns.
Pitta's saying, hey, Jabal Sheer, jump. Force me to jump.
He's wrong.
You know, I'm a big believer that for years offensive linemen had to hold their water. So I don't know why you give them an out here. You know what I mean?
Right.
Let's stay in your stance. You're a tight end. You're an offensive lineman. You've been coached that way.
Cam Cameron, the offensive coordinator for the Ravens, sees his team back now at the 14-yard line. Three wideouts for Flacco. Joe looked over to Rice, now scrambles and throws it to Ray. Oh, what a move, but he lost yardage.
If Billy Wynn doesn't make that tackle, Ray's going to cut it all the way back across the green and probably score. Now, did he catch this one-handed? I want to see if this is a one-hand grab here. Flacco's pump fakes, comes out of the pocket, one-hand grab.
With the left hand.
And if Billy Wynn doesn't make that tackle, I think he's out the gate.
Tyrod Taylor, the backup quarterback, is in as an extra receiver. Flacco, down the middle, touchdown, Torrey Smith on a strike of 18 yards. And Joe Flacco puts some smoke on that one.
You can't throw that football any better. It's over the underneath coverage of Craig Robertson. It's in front of the safety. Over Robertson's head, in front of the safety. Joe plants that back foot. The ball is out right now. Over the head, in between the triangle of Cleveland Browns players. Beautifully thrown and a really nice route by Torrey Smith.
And now the extra point's going to be botched. The only part of that drive that didn't look good, the extra point attempt. Snap, a little bit wide. Cook couldn't handle it, and it's 6-0 Ravens. Don't forget NFL Total Access, the daily source for the latest NFL news, including live reports from around the league, in-depth analysis and interviews with the game's biggest stars. Tomorrow night, Clay Matthews of the Packers will join us, talking about their heartbreaking loss to the Seahawks and their Sunday matchup with the Saints. Total Access tomorrow night and every night, 7 o'clock Eastern, only on NFL Network. An 85-yard drive and 6 plays, culminated by the Flacco to Smith touchdown, 6-0 with the botched extra points. As we take you back to the scoring toss that capped that 2-minute, 53-second drive, Mike.
Yeah, they're going to rotate to two deep safeties here. And when you get the underneath receiver running here, you're going to lose at this point. You're concerned right here. And what I love is he keeps the route here. Bends it back to the inside, but doesn't allow the inside linebacker to become part of it underneath.
Flacco perfect on the drive, actually had more passing yardage than the scoring drive was because of the penalty. 4 for 4 for 87 yards.
Wow.
Fourth straight time the Browns have had to work from their own 20. Weeden comes up throwing low and incomplete. Travis Benjamin, the rookie out of Miami. And that pass really didn't give him a chance.
He's the guy that's coming on a little bit for them, and he's one of the fastest players in the National Football League, and they look for creative ways to get him touches. Fourth round pick out of Miami. He's a legitimate 4-3 guy.
He had a couple of catches and a touchdown in Sunday's loss to Buffalo. You saw Joe Flacco on the phone and the rain coming down now as Trent Richardson bulls his way for 5 yards out to the 25. It'll be 3rd and 5. And if the weather continues like this, the Browns are going to need all of Trent Richardson they can get.
And I've been saying from the very beginning, Brad, that they've got to stay true to who they are right now. It's an AFC North game. It's a punch-in-the-mouth game. You got to run the football and play defense.
Richardson goes out as they bring in the extra receiver, open the eyes, and a slot to the left side. And Weeden in the gun on third and five. Here comes a blitz from Ray Lewis. Weeden fires incomplete. Intended for Obanaya. And Cleveland's got to kick it away again.
Yeah, Obanaya is a running back that can split out wide. He's got nine receptions, but really good coverage by the nickel linebacker, Danelle Ellerby.
Reggie Hodges has been a busy punter tonight for the Browns here in the first half. This is his fourth kick coming up. Again, nice kick. High. Jones camps under it. Fair catch at the last second. And he's run over. I don't know if it was his own man or not. Flags are down. There was a Brown in the vicinity and also one of his own guys.
Yeah, I want to see if he got pushed or blocked into him. That's Jonathan Bottomosi. Can't see from behind there whether or not Jimmy Smith pushed him. There's certainly contact.
Already we had one returner injured in the game. We don't need another one.
And here we see from behind. Jimmy Smith gives him a little bit of a left elbow into the back.
Fifth fair catch interference. Kicking team. Number 41, 15-yard penalty from the spot of the foul. First down, Baltimore. Timeout.
So Jones takes one for the team. The penalty will give Joe Flacco and Ray Rice some better room to work when we come back. Having won 12 regular season games in a row and 13 straight at home, there's the best home record since 2008, 30-5. Big part of the reason is the guy that's dropping back to pass. Flacco goes to Lante Leach, the fullback. And the big fella taken out of bounds very close to a first down. Scott Fujita, the outside linebacker, got him. They'll mark him out after a pickup of eight.
If Flacco's 10 for 13 and outside of a bad decision in the red zone, has had an impeccable game. And I feel like he's getting in the rhythm now.
Yep, he was perfect on the last drive. Back to Ray Rice. First down run into Brown territory at the 45-yard line. Pickup of seven. You see Ray Rock walking next to his offensive lineman. There's his touches so far. Since 2009, only Maurice Jones-Drew, the Jaguars, has more. Flacco, quick throw, and a slant, Torrey Smith. Another first down. Pick up a 15 more.
The corner is soft and off here. They just run the slant, put it on them, move the chains.
Well, that's just pitch and catch. Torrey Smith, who's got the touchdown tonight. And there's the numbers for Joe Flacco. He's hit his last six. Play action, loads, goes for Smith in the corner of the end zone. Almost caught. Nice coverage by Patterson back there in the corner of the end zone.
I told you pregame they were going to take 6 to 8 deep shots. They've already gone at least 3 or 4 hip to hip by Patterson. As a defensive back, you can't play that any better unless you come up with the football. Hip to hip. Turn your eyes back, find the football, use your body. Really good job. Textbook by Demetrius Patterson.
Patterson, a guy that joined the Browns last year as an unrestricted free agent. Second down at 10. At the 30. Rice. Maybe got three. Reuben on the inside. The defensive tackle made the stop.
Couple ex-Philadelphia Eagles in that secondary, and you remember Thomas Heckert is the GM and came over from Philadelphia. Shelton Brown, Demetri Patterson, Gokong was an Eagle.
And of course, the coaching staffs were together with Philadelphia.
Yep, both head men. Yep. Yep, Pat and John both coached under Andy Reid.
Third and seven. Flacco down the sideline. Diving attempt by Pitta, his tight end, couldn't quite get to it.
You know, they got the matchup they wanted. Robertson actually took a shot at him down the field. They could have called a penalty here. Robertson takes a shot down the field. They got the matchup. Joe waited for him to come clean. But I'm telling you, there was a penalty on that down the field, and Flacco wants it.
Tucker, the rookie, is going to try a 45-yard field goal. Perfect so far in the season, including a clutch one Sunday. Snaps a little bit high, but the kick is good. Justin Tucker. 45-yard field goal. The lead increases for the Ravens to 9-0. What was a beautiful night earlier has turned into a rainy one here in Baltimore at M&T Bank Stadium. But the home team just capped off another scoring drive, 32 yards and 7 plays. Justin Tucker, who's got it teed up to kick off, capped it with a 45-yard field goal. This time, Travis Benjamin, the rookie, is going to try to do something with it. Didn't make it to the 20-yard line. Just under 10 minutes remaining in the half. With NFL Game Rewind, get access to coaches' film and full replays of every game from the first 3 weeks of the season. On demand, in HD. Try it at NFL.com/Game Rewind. Well, the Browns had to start their last four drives at the 20, Mike. Now they start at the 17-yard line. They're not gaining much ground here in the first half.
No, and they really need a couple of first downs, A, to give their defense a little bit of a rest, and they've got to slow down this Raven momentum.
Trent Richardson works his way outside. He's upended by Webb, who got him after a pickup of 3.
You know, this LaDarius Webb, third-round pick out of Nickel State in his fourth year, is so valuable to this defense. All we talk about is Ed Reed, and we talk about Ray Lewis, and now Haloti Ngata.
Right.
That young man has upgraded their secondary. Jimmy Smith is a first-round pick, fighting to get in the lineup. They're a much better secondary since they drafted that guy.
And, you know, when you talk to Reed and Lewis and those guys, you say, who are some of the young guys that are maybe the next up-and-coming leaders? They name that kid.
Him and Flacco were the first two names.
Yep. Throw. Probably should have been caught. Jordan Cameron couldn't hold it. It was thrown a little bit behind him.
And the common denominator in this Ravens franchise since 96 is Ozzie Newsome and the way he's drafted and the type of player he drafts. And I'm going to tell you a couple things. Number one, they're productive college players. And number two, they're tough as nails. Ozzie Newsome's one of the best talent evaluators in the business.
And ironically enough, is still the all-time reception leader in Cleveland Browns history. Third and 7. Brandon Weeden, quick drop, and he'll get dropped.
They only rushed 3 players. So this is a 5-on-3 situation with your offensive line versus the Baltimore defensive line. You can't lose this. Look at it. It's 5-on-3. Right tackle, the rookie right there, Mitchell Schwartz, gets beat. Second-round pick from Cal. And this kid, Paul Kruger's gotten better and better, bigger and faster. Another one of those developmental guys Ozzie's drafted.
Hodges, high snap from his own goal line to punt. Jones runs up, late fair catch again, and now he has to get out of the way, and flags fly in. Last time we had interference on the fair catch.
Oh, we got a fight going on here. Helmets off the whole bit. Bottomosi, who's been one of the most active special teams players for Cleveland all season long.
James Territor will have the call for us.
During the kick, illegal use of the hands. Hands of the face, number 22 of the receiving team. The penalty is 10 yards from the end of the kick. First down, Baltimore, timeout.
Smith with the penalty. Jimmy Smith. Brandon Weeden not getting a lot of time to do anything. On Sundays, NFL Network brings you everything you need to know from sunrise through the final gun on Sunday night. Starts off 7 a.m. Eastern Time, first on the field, live reports from all the big games. 9-1 game day morning prepares you for all the Sunday's games. At 4, we break down the early games for you on game day scoreboard and then a recap of all the day's action on game day highlights, 7:30 p.m. Eastern Time. Finally, end your Sunday with game day final at 11:30 Eastern for highlights, press conferences, and analysis from all the games. Live reports from Sunday night's football game. Sunday is game day here on NFL Network. This is our Thursday night matchup. We've got 10 more of these coming up for you. And right now, the Ravens at home leading Cleveland 9-0. Pierce got about 4.
Do a great job. Watch him coming across the kick out block here. Michael Orr, the big left tackle, pulling to his right. great job. The read by Pierce, and then finish the run. It's 4 yards, but it keeps you in line with the chains. You're on target with the chains.
Pierce, obviously a bigger back than Ray Rice. Flacco, blitz coming. Took one in the chest as he threw incomplete to Torrey Smith. DeQuell Jackson said hello to Joe Flacco.
And they had a chance to make a play here because the corner, Sheldon Brown, fell down. Two people plant him. DeQuell Jackson and Billy Wynn, the defensive tackle, the rookie from Boise, really did a nice job beating Matt Burke up the middle.
This would be a big stop for the Cleveland defense if they could get the ball back here. It's third down and six with 8 minutes remaining in the half. Ray Rice back in there. They almost got, and they did get to Flacco. Sheard was there first, and then Reuben cleaned up.
Yeah, that was an inside twist stunt. The two defensive tackles did an X stunt. Say boom and boom like that. Sheard from the outside. Here comes Ataba Reuben from the inside beating Harewood. There's the twist. Really good job by Ataba Reuben, who I think is one of the least publicized players, but is good football player in the National Football League.
He started the last 40 games for him, had 5 sacks last year. That's his first one of this season, as Cook's got to kick it away. Benjamin just lets it go. It goes out of bounds at about the 4-yard line. Well, they're going to walk it up to the 6. Nonetheless, great kick. Good kick by Cook. And Brandon Weeden comes back out with 7:24 remaining. 22nd overall pick in the draft. First rookie quarterback to start a season opener for the Browns. He had really good game against the Bengals a couple of weeks ago, and that was probably their most impressive game when he put up 322 yards and a couple of touchdowns. But tonight, he hasn't been given time, and he hasn't been given field position. And now he's working at his own 6-yard line, and Trent Richardson standing on the goal line. Wants a quick pass, waiting too long as he puts it down the sideline, incomplete. Jordan Cameron, the intended receiver.
Yeah, Ladarius Webb jumped the hitch again, and Weeden did a good job by not throwing it immediately because Webb would have picked his pocket. Watch Webb and how aggressive he is. This is a tight end. He's not afraid of his speed. He jumped the hitch, forced the fade, and Bernard Pollard came over top.
Folks in that end zone are going to make it rough on the Browns right here. Blitz off the corner. Richardson trying to run by some of that traffic, and he got it out to the 12. The possessions for the Browns, they have not done much with the football, obviously looking with a 0 on the scoreboard.
Yeah, the field position's been bad. They've struggled with a rookie quarterback, a rookie right tackle, a rookie tailback, 2 rookie receivers. They're going to be inconsistent at best, but they need to make a play here, Ness. They can't let this game get away from them.
Mike, this is their shortest third down of the night. There's Colt McCoy, the backup quarterback, the starter of the last year and a half. Now it's Whedon's turn on a third down at 4 that they need just to change field position a little bit, if nothing else. Whedon throws. It's complete, and it is a first down. Ben Watson, the tight end.
Yeah, and he was fortunate. I thought he held on to that football too long. I thought they might get a piece of this ball before it got to Ben Watson. See Pollard, 31. Remember, it's going to 82 Watson right here. He's coming from distance. I thought he had a chance to make a play on the ball. First down, Browns.
One that they desperately needed. 6 minutes remaining in the half. They trail 9-0. Now Weeden to throw on first down into traffic. Lucky that one didn't get picked off by Kruger. Ray Lewis was in the vicinity, too.
Yeah, Kruger's played a heck of a game here. He's got a sack. Ray Lewis coming from the inside, Kruger coming from the outside. And I think one thing young quarterbacks do, Brad, is they tend to stare down the receivers.
Right.
You get a better jump. And when we talked to Brandon Weeden yesterday, I said, what's the most important thing for you tomorrow night? He said, eye discipline. I can't make it easier for those guys.
Here's Brad Childress, former Viking head coach, the offensive coordinator in his first year with Cleveland. Second down and 10, Weeden under center, drops the throw. Wants to go long, and does. Man out there's got it. Greg Little. Nice throw by Weeden, and Little doesn't drop that one.
Wow. Is that a great catch? And that's what's so captivating about Greg Little. He's a big, strong, fast guy working on Kerry Williams one-on-one. I thought Williams might have interfered with him. He never turned around, but great concentration, wonderful catch, brings the ball into his body, maintains it through the ground. Wow.
That's got to give Weeden a little bit of confidence, too. This is their first trip into Raven territory, first down at the 39.
Huge.
Remember, they're only down 9 points.
Yeah, that's a huge play for Cleveland.
Cameron, the tight end in motion. Here comes a blitz. It's picked up momentarily. Now Weeden, a skipped rock out there that could have been intercepted. Jameel McClain, I said they picked up the blitz, but he came over the top of it and still got a hit on the Cleveland quarterback.
You've got to be careful, because if you're going to cut, here comes the linebacker. If you're going to cut him, he can get up and still make a play. I'd much rather see my running back, Trent Richardson, eat up some ground, stay square, and don't cut him.
That's a wicked hit Weeden took. Now an eye backfield. Marisic in there in front of Trent Richardson. Play action, Weeden to the outside, complete. Benjamin broke a tackle, broke two, might have a first down.
Missed tackle by Webb. I've been talking about the kid all night long. He took a bad angle, and Travis Benjamin's the guy they got to start getting the football to. Back foot hits, no hitch, gets the ball out. Webb with a bad angle, and a good job by the tiny Travis Benjamin. 5'9 and a half, 175, fourth round pick out of Miami.
Saw him several times with the Hurricanes, and he is lightning in a bottle when he gets his hands on it.
Marisic didn't know what to do.
Eighth play of the drive, Richardson. McClain holding on for dear life. But look at Trent Richardson. Just keep dragging Ravens with him for a 7-yard gain.
You want to talk about leg power and drive. Forget all the blocking and everything else. Just take a look at first contact right here. McClain's got the hit. And now watch to the leg drive, holding onto the football, turning, pushing, staying up, still driving. Man, that might not be an 80-yard run, but that's pretty darn cool.
Sure was. At the 20-yard line on a drive for the Browns who started at their own six. Weeden across the middle. Pick up a five. Obanaya out of the backfield.
Remember, Obanaya had 9 catches coming into the game. He's a tailback that catches the football well and pass protects. He just ran a little arrow route. Caught the football and you moved the chains.
3.5 minutes remaining in the first half, and Cleveland threatening here now at the 15-yard line. Trent Richardson checks back in.
It's a great drive for Cleveland.
Without a mistake, they'll get something out of this. Blitz again. Weeden fires at the goal line to the 1-yard line. And a pickup of 14, and again, it's Travis Benjamin.
Yeah, I think it's so important they get the football to Travis Benjamin. He's so fast. Good block out here by Joe Thomas on Kruger. But Benjamin is so darn fast. Corners give him room. Look at Jimmy Smith way off of him. Even though you're in the compressed area of the field, the red zone, people are scared to death of his speed. And that ball's on time and on target.
Extra lineman in on first and goal at the 1. Richardson on a toss. Trying to get to the corner. He'll make it. Touchdown, Cleveland. Third rushing touchdown of the year for the rookie out of Alabama.
Yeah, that Jason Pinkston was pulled out and was supposed to block for him. He just even outran his own offensive guard.
1 yard touchdown, capping a 94-yard drive.
Pinkston's going to pull. Watch Richardson get ahead of him. Don't need you. I'm getting to the corner. And by the way, touchdown. Good block by Marisic. We got a ball game, Ness.
We sure do. Phil Dawson, longtime kicker, in for the point after. High snap. It's handled, and so's the extra point. As Mike said, we do indeed have an AFC North ball game, 9-7. 2:32 remaining in the first half. Can't have a drive look much better than that one. 11 plays, 94 yards. Weeden to Greg Little was a big part of it, a 39-yarder, and then Trent Richardson and company went to work on the ground. And the first 5 possessions, almost nothing. 50 more yards on that drive alone than they had done to that point.
I really like the blend on that drive also. Power running by Trent Richardson. The big play, obviously, and you said it, Brad, Greg Little, who's had a history of dropping the football, makes a spectacular play, and that's why he was a second-round pick, because the kid kind of tantalizes you with his ability,
right,
but he's not consistent yet.
Remember that third and four they picked up down there around the 20 when they threw it to the tight end?
Huge
they didn't
play.
Have that.
Huge
that
play.
That doesn't happen.
Yep.
So Dawson to kick. Deontay Thompson is back deep. Thompson, a rookie out of Florida.
Yeah, an undrafted rookie. Flies. Really flies.
He might have a chance to take flight here from 5 yards deep. Thompson won't make it to the 20-yard line. Nice coverage. Craig Robertson, who had an interception earlier in the game. Nice job on the special teams. Tonight's aerial coverage is being presented by Southwest Airlines.
It's a pretty cool city, isn't it, Brad?
Sure is.
Look at the water there, the waterfront. They do a wonderful job, and it's not an overpoweringly big city. It's easy to get around. I think this is a pretty cool place to hang out.
We spent a little time on the water last night. Had a great time. At the 19-yard line now, Flacco and company with 2:26 and their full complement of timeouts plus the two-minute warning. Joe throws short to Ray Rice. Rice, a great move, spins his way and gets out to the 30-yard line.
Hey, that's vintage Ray Rice. Reminds me so much of Marshall Faulk, which we'll talk about later in the second half. But just a little check down, gets your drive started.
Now the throw to the outside, Anquan Boldin, who hadn't caught one until now. And we're at the two-minute warning with the Ravens on the move. But their lead's been cut to two. Ravens 9, Browns 7, 2 minutes remaining first half.
Rich Eisen walking through the raindrops to let you know what's coming up on our Lexus halftime show. Michael Irvin with Julio Jones, Roddy White, and highlights of this game.
Don't you know enough to come in out of the rain, Rich? See you guys in 2 minutes. Second and four. Flacco comes up throwing complete. Jacoby Jones has got a first down. Remember, all three timeouts remaining for the Ravens. And they go, obviously, without a huddle here.
Keep in mind the Browns, without their best defensive player, Joe Hayden, still out on suspension tonight and one more week.
False start.
Offense, number 74. 5-yard penalty. First down.
Michael Orr, new spot for him this year, Mike.
Yeah, he was on the right side a year ago. Left side now. Jaquay Parker, the former Eagle, the defensive end in their sub package, a little quicker than Frosty Rucker, and Michael got caught cheating a little bit.
Plus, it makes more sense that he's back on the blind side.
Yeah, I knew you were going there.
First and 15. Flacco stands tall, throws incomplete, intended for Jones again. Nice play by Buster Skrine over there, the second-round cornerback.
Yeah, and he comes from Tennessee, Chattanooga, and Skrine's a young guy with great feet. Watch his transition out of his back pedal. He's going to drive to the inside shoulder and almost come up with the football.
And they've said second-round cornerback. I meant second-year cornerback. Second and 15. Flacco buys himself a little more time. Running out of it now. And throwing long for Jones, and he overshot him. And Patterson and Skrine were both there with him the whole way.
Well, did a great job in the secondary there. Dennis Pitta, who was, I believe, been held without a catch, reaches up. You're not going to catch that football with a face mask,
no,
are you?
Not with a big orange glove in your face.
You know, I don't think we've... Have we seen Dennis Pitta catch a ball tonight?
They aimed one at him, but he didn't catch it. Flacco across the middle. Ray Rice doesn't make the first guy miss. Nice open field tackle by Craig Robertson. He's had a good game, Robertson has.
Yeah, when we talked to Dick Geron, the defensive coordinator for Cleveland, I think he was very happy with the upgrade in speed and athleticism this year with his linebackers. And when they go to three wide, Robertson's on the field. And Robertson is a sure tackler, and he moves more like a safety.
There's Dick, defensive coordinator for the Browns. Cleveland took a timeout because they want to save all the clock they can, because they're going to get the football with the punt upcoming. Sam Cook to kick. That's Travis Benjamin counting all his guys, making sure he's got 10 in front of him. The last punt for Cook, he knocked out of bounds at the 6-yard line. Mile high on this one. And it makes the end zone. So Cleveland will have it after a 54-yard kick at their own 20-yard line. After tonight, you can catch 10 more games of Thursday Night Football next Thursday. Currently, the undefeated Arizona Cardinals. Kevin Cobb, maybe the surprise team. They'll take on Sam Bradford and the Rams from St. Louis next Thursday, 8 o'clock on NFL Network.
Is that the 3-0 Arizona Cardinals?
It is, and they play Miami this weekend. They might be 4-0 when we get there. Mike and Alex and I will be there along with all the guys, Rich and the gang, so we hope you join us next Thursday night.
Yeah, I really believe the reason they're winning is not because of Larry Fitzgerald and their offense, but their defense has played at a high level since the last half of last year.
Nada! Nada! Loss of three.
I'm telling you, he's a dancing bear. It's unbelievable. 340 pounds. Boom. So quick. Just swims Alex Mack into the backfield. Now, people always talk about what did they do? Did these guys ever play a different sport? Why are they so athletic? This kid played rugby in high school. I mean, it's mind-boggling when you see a young 18-year-old Haloti Ngata. Brad, do you want to tackle him?
No. Neither do these
neither
guys.
Him.
He led Highland Rugby Club to the Rugby National Championship. He's in the stiff arm and a hurdle there.
Just
watch this. Watch
pull
the end
his
of this
pants
play.
Down. Yeah. You gotta, that's the only way you're going to stop
that's right.
him.
Pull down pull his shorts trousers. And that's
yep,
it.
That's it.
Nobody's
man.
Been able to pull down his pants tonight so far. Second down and 12. Weeden. Pocket collapsing, but he got it away. Obaniah picked up five. They're going to have to hustle, though. They're under a minute.
Timeout this time. Baltimore, correct?
Yep.
Yeah. Little chess match with the coaches.
Ravens going to take their second timeout and try to maybe come up with a block punt if they can get a stop. So far tonight, the Ravens have had all they can handle on their friends from Cleveland that they've beaten eight straight times.
You know what? I mean, I try to tell people all week long, this is a divisional battle. And in the AFC North, it's a low-scoring, slobber knocker, bring your helmet and don't come out flat.
Right.
You know, and they had an emotional win, Baltimore did last Sunday night. And it's tough to come back and have to play on Thursday against a division rival.
Remember, they had an interception in the end zone and a missed extra point, or maybe they'd have a bigger lead right now. Here comes a blitz on Weeden. Little jump pass, and that ball is out. Or was it not caught? Norwood, I think they're going to say incomplete, and they will.
Yeah, and remember, there has to be possession and an element of time, and I don't think that element of time was there. The catch, does he get both feet down and an element of time to make a football move? I don't think so. Can't challenge. We're at the end of the half here.
Browns haven't had a punt blocked in a long, long time.
Uh-oh. Don't shoot the clown.
I'm just saying. 1993, the last time they had one stuffed. Hodges might want to keep that in mind and get rid of this thing in a hurry. And this one's going to come over to the Ravens side.
Yeah, where are they going to mark this?
Mark it.
Yep. Getting a lot of help over there, aren't
the
they,
coaches
Brad?
Are pointing at midfield.
Yeah, let's see where he goes.
He's still coming to the 45. So they've got 40 seconds and a timeout to work with.
That's
you don't ever want to give a quality quarterback and
right.
a team with one timeout 40 seconds.
And that's the downside of Pat Shurmur using that timeout on the previous possession to stop the clock
yep.
for his offense.
Exactly.
Here's my man.
I'm telling you, you and I thought about that today.
You think that was father-son?
Neither of them have gone bald yet, we know that. First down. Trips up to the top of your screen. Flacco wanted to come back the other way and never had time because of Jamal Sheard.
Boy, Flacco's been under some pressure, and it's been four-man pressure from Cleveland. Michael Orr gets beaten by Juque Parker. The right tackle gets beat off the edge.
Going to throw a safe one to Ray Rice. And again, Robertson, who's been all over the field, makes the stop.
30-second timeout.
We've got 10 seconds remaining. And you see Weeden, his knuckle on his right hand bleeding. Both quarterbacks have been roughed up a little bit in this first half.
A good four-man pressure by Cleveland. Jabal Sheard from one side, Juque Parker from the other. They're causing Michael Orr and Coleccio Semele some issues.
So now it's third down and 19 for the Ravens.
32.
Flacco steps up, pressure from behind, incomplete. And we're down to four ticks remaining.
And the last thing you really want to do is oh, there's Steve Bisciotti and Ozzie Newsom.
Bisciotti, the owner, and Ozzie Newsom, general manager, trying to stay dry. Jamal Lewis being honored here in the Ring of Honor at halftime. That's why those guys are down on the field. Jamal, who had a 2,000-yard season back in 2003 with the Ravens. So the offense staying out there, I think they're just going to take a snap, back up a second,
right,
and kneel down. They don't want to
chance a punt. Exactly.
Unless they throw, and Cleveland thinking that has four guys about 50 yards downfield.
Yep.
And they are going to air one out, hoping for a pass interference, but that obviously is thrown out of bounds just to let the 4 seconds go.
Joe said we're going to the locker room.
Yeah, let's go to the locker room and dry out. Good half, hard-hitting half, 9-7, Ravens at the end of two. Stay tuned. Lex's Halftime Show. Rich and the guys are coming up next. Take this opportunity to remind you that you can follow your favorite teams all season long at iTunes.com/NFL. And there you see the weather intensifying. And some of our guys, our camera guys in here with us quickly to try to dry off at halftime, said that there has been some major lightning. We quite frankly can't see it because of the overhang we have near our booth, but it's raining Browns and Ravens right now.
I just ran into one of the Baltimore executives, and he shook his head and said, yep, AFC North.
Yep, at least it's not snowing. Deontay Thompson from about 8 yards deep took a risk, and it didn't pay off. He got leveled at the 11-yard line. Let's check in with Alex.
Hey, Bradwell, the Ravens not off to the fast start that they were hoping for tonight. Maybe one of the reasons is because of the pressure Cleveland has been able to get on Joe Flacco. They've been bringing some heat on him, and John Harbaugh telling me at the half that he feels like they've been beat occasionally one-on-one in the first half. Pat Shurmur telling me they will continue to try and pressure Joe Flacco, and as Mike Mayock said, Brad, we have a divisional, what did he call it, slobber knocker underway, the rain coming down right now.
This is the worst starting field position for the Ravens at their own 11-yard line to open up the third quarter. Flacco play fake. Stands at his own goal line. Crossing route. Ray Rice, the intended receiver. I think Ray felt he was held.
I think Joe did too. Kaluka Maeva having a conversation with Ray Rice.
There's the quarterback comparison. Brandon Weeden warmed up on that last drive of the second quarter a little bit. And Flacco was perfect on the touchdown scoring drive that the Ravens had. Brown show blitz. They're going to bring it. The throw. Torrey Smith out to the 19-yard line. Fujita, the linebacker, got out there and made the stop. And it'll bring up third down and a couple.
Yeah, Dimitri Patterson had a chance to make a play and somehow missed his tackle. I don't know why he did. Jumped the route very quickly. Took a bad angle.
Yep. So the thing you'd want to do if you're Cleveland is force a Ravens punt on their opening possession of the third quarter. They'd have to stop a third down and two to do that here. And they won't be able to because of Ray Rice. Almost broke it into the next level to Sean Gibson, the rookie out of Wyoming, with a shoestring tackle. But Ray got eight.
Watch this unorthodox block by Michael Orr. All of a sudden he's going to stand backwards.
That's not your blind side. That's your backside.
That's your backside block on Billy Wynn.
Oh, boy.
Oh, boy. Which way are we going here, Ramon Harewood? They're coaching the offensive lineman to jump when the neutral zone is infringed by a defensive player.
Which was Billy Wynn.
Neutral zone infraction, defense. Number 90 was in the neutral zone, causing the offense false start, 5-yard penalty, first down.
As Mike called it.
You see the jump, and Harewood is coached to jump into the neutral zone so that Wynn is caught before he can get back.
So first down at 5 at the 32. Flacco quick throws high, intended for Jacoby Jones. That one just kind of got away from Joe, and he says, my fault, but it is wet out there. And that could have a bearing on the passing game of this entire half now.
They took several deep shots in the first half. We talked about how good they are in their vertical game. Torrey Smith takes the top off of any defense. See, now the ball's out there. That's a wet football, and most of the time, quarterbacks don't mind that. It's the wind they don't like.
A back shoulder throw to Anquan Boldin. That's a perfect strike.
This guy is so darn strong. He's working against Dimitri Patterson. Patterson's got great coverage. Boldin anticipates the back shoulder. Look at him. That's just a great job with his hands.
Back to the ground. And Rice got 3. Anquan Boldin, Mr. Dependable, closing in on 10,000 career receiving yards. And as you said, there's not too many guys as strong at the wide receiver position in the NFL.
He ran famously, I think, like 4.66 coming out of Florida State. It cost him some draft position, but, man, what a productive career.
Again, trying to get it out to Rice. Incomplete.
An awful lot of pressure. That time they bring the safety. T.J. Ward off the edge. He's completely untouched. And Joe Flacco's got to get rid of the football quickly.
Again, the Ravens stay out there, not necessarily hurrying, but not going with a huddle.
Yeah.
So here's third down and 7.
Hey.
Flacco steps up, fires far side. What a catch by Anquan Boldin. First down, Ravens.
Now, when Joe Flacco can step up into a solid pocket, he's as good as any quarterback you'll ever see. Watch the protection here. That's a perfect cup. He steps into the void between the guard and tackle, and look where he puts that football.
Couldn't have been placed any better. Ray Rice for a couple. Daquell Jackson, the middle linebacker, made the stop. So it's been the Anquan Boldin drive so far for the Ravens here, opening up the third quarter.
It really showcases, A, his body control, the way he was able to flip around and make the hands catch on the back shoulder. And then again, B, runs that deep bow out, extends. Pretty special.
Flacco in the shotgun. Torrey Smith comes in motion toward the ball. Joe's looking that way. Completes a throw to Boldin again, his third catch on the drive. And he's got it first and goal, and he almost snuck into the end zone.
Yeah, man.
21 more yards.
Wow.
I was going to say, he's had 32 career 100-yard games. He might hit 100 on this drive when it's over.
You know, he's working on the inside. He's against zone. That's Buster's screen in a zone. Makes him look bad. Breaks his ankles. Then he runs through a couple tackles. And we see everything there. Strength, speed, toughness exemplified.
First and goal for the Ravens. Opening drive of the third at the 2-yard line of the Browns. Ray Rice makes one man miss, but only gets a yard.
Yeah, Frosty Rucker got immediate pressure. Just a good cut by Rice in the backfield to keep the play alive.
Rucker signed as a free agent in the offseason after 6 years with Cincinnati. And now the wide receivers go out. The extra tight ends come in.
Yeah, Cleveland's the youngest team in the league. Their starters average under 26 years of age, and they picked up Rucker and Juque Parker as the only two free agents on defense.
Bryant McKinney in as an extra tackle as well. Second and goal at the one. Rice, and again, knocked down before he can get to the end zone. About the 1 foot line.
Yeah, it's a good job there by TJ Ward. Safety coming over the top, number 43. He's going to come in and make the tackle. Jumps right over Vontae Leach, does a heck of a job. They get no push inside.
Third down and goal at about the 1 foot line. Same formation. Play action. Flacco, nothing but green grass in front of him. Touchdown.
That's a great job by Joe Flacco, because he wanted Dennis Pitta in the back of the end zone, and Pitta fell down.
1 yard touchdown run by Joe Flacco. Caps an 89-yard drive, mostly to Anquan Boldin. And it took the opening 5 minutes and 7 seconds of the third quarter. This extra point is good. Flacco did it with his arm to Anquan Boldin to get him close. Then he did it with his legs from a yard out. 16-7, Ravens. Anquan Boldin had 3 catches for 60 yards on that 89-yard drive. Travis Benjamin's going to bring it out from 7 yards deep, and probably shouldn't have. Didn't get it to the 15-yard line. And Brandon Weeden finds himself buried inside his own 20 for what seems like the 100th time tonight. His counterpart, Joe Flacco, has given the Ravens a 9-point lead. With the most complete information and analysis, 4 o'clock we break down the early games for you on Game Day Scoreboard. Then it's a recap of all the day's action on Game Day Highlights at 7:30. And finally, Game Day Final at 11:30 Eastern for highlights, press conferences, and analysis from all the games, including live reports from the Sunday night game. Sunday is Game Day here on NFL Network. Ray trying to get the crowd into it, and he has successfully, as he's done for 17 years. Trent Richardson bottled up after maybe a 2-yard gain. Alani Nata on the inside, Mike, has been all that the Browns can handle.
And this is why he's so special, okay? Watch him working on Pinkston. He stacks them, controls them, vision on the back to know how he should shed, and look at the quickness to make the tackle at 340. Now, watch him push the pocket in the pass game. Double team, jacks him back into the quarterback, and again in the run game. Little swim move. Brad, the quickness at 340 is mind-boggling to me.
Second down and 7. Blitz is coming on Weeden, who throws successfully incomplete. Going to be short of the first down, I think, by about a yard. Greg Little made the catch. You know, the Browns have had 8 total possessions tonight, and every time they've started at their own 20 or worse, and they're trying to just dig themselves out of this one.
Right. With a rookie quarterback, a rookie right tackle. I'll tell you one thing about Greg Little. It seems like the harder the catch, the easier he makes it.
How about that?
You know, I think he just reacts as an athlete rather than thinking about it.
Now here's a big third down at 2-4. Marisic, the fullback, is in there. They fake it to Richardson. Weeden wants to go to him and does, and he made the catch. And he's got extra yardage down the sideline before Ray Lewis can bring him out of bounds.
Pretty good coverage by Pollard, but a real good throw. Very accurate by Brandon Weeden. The play action, he's going to slip out here. 31, just Bernard Pollard. One misstep. He slips a little bit, tries to undercut the route. And now, look at the quickness of the 230-pound first-round pick. That's pretty good, man.
15-yard pickup and a first down from the 37. Ravens show blitz. They come with it. Weeden stands in and delivers across the middle to Benjamin Watson. And a penalty marker coming in. Pollard might be a helmet-to-helmet here. Watson, the veteran, ninth-year man out of Georgia with a catch down the middle that'll become a first down, and they'll tack yardage onto it.
Yeah, the inline tight end was wide open.
Foul. Unnecessary roughness. Helmet contact with the defensive receiver, number 31. 15 yards automatic. First down.
Well, that's the first down tonight. The regular officials have really been booed.
Yeah, now the inline receiver, Watson, remember, you have to be a defenseless player first. When you're reaching for the ball, you are. Any helmet to the neck or head area is illegal, whether you like it or not.
Richardson trying to bounce it outside, and he won't get away from McClellan after a pickup of two.
So the net result of that, Brad, it wasn't a particularly vicious hit, but you can't target the neck or head area, and that's a correct call.
Terrell Suggs, right now an injured reserve player of the year on defense last season. They could use him, that's for sure. Weeden pump fakes. Wants to go deep and does. In and out of the hands of Norwood. And at the last second, Lardarius Webb got a hand in there.
Yeah, good protection, and they were man-to-man across the board. Pollard was the free safety in the middle of the field. So, five men up, how many are coming? Four are coming with a twist. Really good protection. But the coverage down the field, one-on-one, Webb finds the ball just at the last moment and strips Norwood.
Crowd is deafening right now. Third down and eight. They'd like to get some yardage just to shorten the field goal attempt. Blitz coming. Weeden down the middle. Skips it off the hands again of Norwood. And that's going to be about a 51-yard kick.
And he had to throw it high. He had underneath coverage. You know, I thought Baltimore was going to target the right side of this Cleveland line because Mitchell Schwartz is a rookie. The left side of the line with Joe Thomas and Jason Pinkston, a little tougher to get into the backfield with.
This guy doesn't miss too many outside 50. Eight of his last nine from 50-plus.
Wow.
The veteran in his 14th year out of Texas. 51-yard field goal attempt by Dawson. Kick on the way. That's why he's been around that long. So Cleveland did get something out of it. And they're still very much in the ballgame. 51-yard field goal by Dawson, and it's 16-10, Ravens. Get free premium access to NFL Mobile from Verizon this weekend through October 1st. Live games Thursday, Sunday, and Monday. Every touchdown from every game Sunday afternoons with NFL Red Zone, 24/7 NFL Network access, and more. Call Star NFL to download NFL Mobile or go to bzw.com/NFL. Dawson's kick. Thompson, 9 yards in the end zone. Wisely does what his rookie counterpart Travis Benjamin didn't do for Cleveland. Take a knee. 6-point game here in Baltimore. Baltimore leading by six with 6:52 remaining. John Harbaugh just turned 50 on Sunday. Fourth coach since the merger in 70 to take the team to the playoffs his first 4 years. That's pretty good company he's in. Chuck Knox and John Robinson with the Rams. Bill Cowher, the Steelers. Two AFC championship games in 08 and last year. And really one of the most highly thought of guys, I think, around the whole league, Mike.
And I give Steve Bisciotti a ton of credit because it was not an easy hire, hiring a guy that was predominantly a special teams coach throughout his career.
Flacco lofts one out, complete to Vontae Leach. And the big fullback has taken some people with it.
Really
including
nice.
Dimitri Patterson.
Yeah, how about the touch over top of Scott Fujita? Great touch, and then the finish by Leach was great. 44 out of the backfield. Got to throw it over the head, drop it in the bucket, and now finish it. At 260 pounds, Dimitri wants no parts of that.
Over at the training camp facility, or the practice facility yesterday, I almost ran into Vontae in the hallway, and he just went, huh? And I got out of the way. Flacco completes. And this has been Anquan Boldin's second half. What a quarter he's put together. That's his fourth catch for 67 yards.
And really nice job using his body to keep Patterson away from the football, because Patterson was all around that.
Bernard Pierce stays in there at the tailback spot. Ray Rice not in there right now. Second down and three. Pierce gets the carry. He's got the first down and a whole bunch more. All the way to the 35-yard line for the rookie from Temple.
When we talked to Cam Cameron, he said the right tackle, Kelechi Osemele, was going to be a star in this league. Watch him collapse the entire right side down. The cutback by Pierce. Drops the pad level, finishes the run.
Picked up 21 yards to the 35. So the Ravens trying to answer that field goal drive. Here's a flea flicker. Flacco off his back foot, throws it out there and incompletes. Anquan Boldin was the closest guy.
Too much pressure again. Fujita came right up the middle and ran over Ray Rice.
And Joe never really had a chance to plant his feet on that one.
He's just trying to get rid of it. Watch Ray Rice step up when Fujita comes up the middle. He throws it back. He's on top of him before he's even got a chance to really see it. Good job by Joe just getting to the football.
Ray couldn't get his head back around in the swivel after pitching the ball back to Flacco.
Exactly.
Second and 10. Crossing route. Completes to the 30-yard line. And Quan Boldin gets blown up by DaQuell Jackson.
How many catches is that for Boldin?
That is five all this quarter.
All second, all third quarter, huh?
DaQuell Jackson, his 29th birthday yesterday, came into our meeting with a whole box of cupcakes.
Didn't leave with a whole box, though.
No, he did not leave with a full box, thanks to you.
Hey, cupcakes, Mike and Ike's, whatever, yep. I'm in.
Third down. Flacco fires. Tucked it in there to the 19-yard line of Torrey Smith. Needed four and got nine.
One of the things that wide receiver coach Jimmy Hostler told me that this kid has learned is he's got to come back to the football. Watch him up the field. Now, when you plan, you got to come back. Don't wait for it. That gives Buster Screen an opportunity to try and break on the football. But uses his body, catches the ball.
They're back in the red zone where they've wasted one opportunity tonight and capitalized the last time they had it. Blitz coming. Flacco, they're going to have him courtesy of some of the pressure from one side. And then John Hughes, who's the guy that actually gets to him. Third sack of the night for Cleveland.
Yeah, he crossed the face of the center, Matt Burke. This is their third-round pick who's going to beat him across his face. And then gets up the field using his hands on Flacco and forces him right into the other pressure. But that's all about the rookie third-round pick from Cincinnati, John Hughes.
Ray Rice splits out to the top of your screen as a wide receiver here in an empty backfield on second down and 16.
He jumped.
And somebody jumped.
Pitta.
Pitta and I think Michael Orr and Pitta both jumps.
That's got to be what, their third or fourth?
Offense number 88, 5-yard penalty, second down.
They had way too many penalties on Sunday night against the Patriots, but they overcame that.
Right.
Fifth on the offensive unit tonight for John Harbaugh's Ravens.
This is the kind of game where you're heavily favored, you're at home, you think you're going to probably take care of business, and the longer you let this underdog hang around, the more you got to be worried.
You're exactly right. Hitta now sets up on the backfield. Flacco had time, running out of it again. And he's got to get rid of this one. Jaquay Parker putting the pressure on him that time.
Yeah, he wanted Torrey Smith, who was double covered between Usama Young and Buster Screen. Looking for him the entire time. Screen is the corner that's off. And there's Usama Young, and there's the double. They've got him in and out. Boom, jump the route. Flacco does a nice job not pulling the trigger there and throwing it away. And to me, Brad, that's the difference between a rookie and a fifth-year quarterback. That's part of the maturation process. You take the hit and you throw it away.
Third down at 21. They've got to get all the way to the 8-yard line for a first down. What they want to do is not come up with a turnover here and give their field goal kicker a chance. Flags down. The pass is incomplete. And again, a penalty marker in the backfield.
Yeah, it looks like another hold.
Now, do you decline this and let them try a longer field goal? You take the penalty and really make it third and a mile.
Hands of the face. Offense, number 72, 10-yard penalty, replay, third down.
Osemele gets beat to his inside. You're going to see The move to the inside by Emmanuel Stevens. Shot to the face and a hold by Yanda. You could have gone either way there.
Yeah.
Yanda held him, and Osemele got the shot to the face.
Mike, they had a first and 10 at the 18-yard line. Now they've got third down and, about 31 maybe, back at the 39?
The key here is field goal, right?
Yeah.
You want to preserve the 3 points. The ball's on the 39 plus 8. That puts you on the 47 or a 57-yard attempt in the rain. So forget the first down. Get yourself 10, 12 yards if you can, and give it a realistic field goal opportunity.
Again, Rice, the fourth receiver. Flacco short over the middle to Bolden.
There it is.
And Anquan Bolden's going to get it to the 29-yard line. Ball almost popped out at the end. But that's going to make it a shorter field goal attempt by the rookie, Justin Tucker. He has hit from 56 already on this young season, and he is perfect on the year.
Just a smart play there, the check down to Bolden, and they did exactly what we said, Brad. They picked up 10, and now it's a much more realistic opportunity.
Ironically, both kickers from Texas, one in his 14th year for the Browns, this guy a rookie. He'll try from 47 yards out. They try to make it a 9-point lead again for the Ravens. The kick's on the way, and he missed it to the right. He had a controversial kick that ended the game against the Patriots that some people thought was over the top of the upright and maybe wide right. This one, there was no doubt. And so the Browns still in a one-possession game with the Ravens. The Browns with the rookie quarterback Brandon Weeden in there, and they have had a lot of different starters over the last 6 years. Charlie Fried, Eric Anderson, Brady Quinn, and more recently, Jake Delhomme, Colt McCoy last year, and now the 22nd overall pick from Oklahoma State, Brandon Weeden, at the controls here, trailing by only six, and back to throw on first down. Fires high, probably could have been caught though. Travis Benjamin went airborne and took one in the back. From Lardarius Webb, incomplete.
Really like the read by Brandon Weeden, because Ed Reed was trying to bait him into throwing the ball down the middle. And Ed Reed has done that to a few rookie quarterbacks in his time, trust me. But Brandon Weeden made the right read. He put it on Benjamin, and he should have caught the football.
28 years old in his rookie season because of that stint in minor league baseball. He's actually older than Aaron Rodgers, the defending MVP of the league, who's played seven seasons. Weeden again. There's a good catch by Jordan Cameron. And here's a guy that they hooked up with five times last week, and they tried to get in the ball. He picks up 15 yards.
Ed Reed wants offensive pass interference because Cameron uses his size, puts his head down. I don't think there's any interference there. All he did was disengage from tough man-to-man coverage. He used his hands. He caught the football. And remember, that's the converted wide receiver from USC to put some weight on.
On first down, back to Trent Richardson. And Trent gets down to the 44, maybe the 43-yard line. It's going to bring up second down and a long five.
He can push a pile now.
He sure can. He could push the weights over in Tuscaloosa in his time at Alabama. He was freakish in the weight room. It kind of shows, doesn't it?
Oh, he's just got that natural lower body strength. He is freakish in the weight room.
He's got muscles that have muscles.
Kind of like you.
Exactly.
I've seen you in that weight room.
Very close. A minute remaining third quarter, second down and five. Browns threatening to try to make it a three-point game or take the lead. And on an end around, Travis Benjamin. And they didn't get much out of that. Webb stayed home, made a nice stop. And it'll bring up third down.
Webb did a really nice job there on the backside. And they're so well coached. Dean Pease, the defensive coordinator, had the same title up in New England a couple years ago.
Here's the biggest third down of the ball game for the Ravens defense to this point as we approach a half minute in the third quarter. Weeden fires, and it's intercepted by Kerry Williams down the sideline and gone. Yards for the touchdown.
Gary Williams just played the chains, the first down chains. It was just a speed out by Benjamin. The ball comes out a little bit late. Really wasn't late, to be honest with you. The ball came out on time. Just a great job by Gary Williams anticipating and jumping the route, playing the first down chains.
His first interception of the year is a pick six. And Justin Tucker's extra point has changed the entire complexion of this late stage of the third quarter.
Now, I thought Gary Williams got picked on a little bit last week against New England. Comes back here. It's just a speed out by Travis Benjamin. Look how tightly he's going to play. Top of the screen. Comes out of the pedal. Sees it immediately. Undercuts it. The ball's obviously thrown behind. That ball, if you're going to make a mistake, you got to make the mistake in front of him out of bounds. Never behind like that.
Played beautifully and taken to the end zone to give the Ravens now a 23-10 lead. Boy, how one play can change everything. And that's the one right now for the Ravens defense.
Yeah, I was about to say that what a clean game this rookie quarterback has played, keeping him into the game. One mistake. And Brad, that's about a difference in 3 feet, that throw. But 3 feet in this league, in college, that's complete. It's first down. They're still in their drive. In the NFL, it's a pick six.
And you thought if they just kept it going, they'd at least get three out of it and make it a field goal game.
Yeah, that's a huge differential right there. You could make the argument very easily that that's a 10-point differential right there.
Tucker to kick. Travis Benjamin is back deep, the guy who was the intended receiver on that play. And last time, he took the kickoff about 8 yards deep in his own end zone and chose to bring it out. And this time, he won't have to worry about that decision. It's made for him. NFL Total Access, a daily source for the latest NFL news, including live reports from around the league, in-depth analysis and interviews with the game's biggest stars. Tomorrow night, pretty big one for the Packers. Clay Matthews joins us to discuss how Green Bay feels about that Sunday loss to the Seahawks and their showdown upcoming with the New Orleans Saints. Catch Total Access tomorrow night and every night, 7 o'clock Eastern Time, only on NFL Network.
How about that NFC North, huh? Green Bay's 1-2, Detroit's 1-2, and somehow the Minnesota Vikings are 2-1.
And they beat the 49ers last weekend.
Yeah, the world's upside down, man.
Sure is. Weeden, who threw an interception on his last pass, complete on this one, but a very short gain, couple of yards maybe for Watson. And that'll bring the third quarter to a close. The Ravens have won 8 straight over the Cleveland Browns. They've got 15 minutes to go to make it 9 in a row. 23-10, Baltimore in front. Tonight's aerial coverage is being presented by Southwest Airlines. Beautiful picture of downtown Baltimore, but a rainy night. And as we get set to start the fourth quarter, 23-10, and you got to clean the cameras too. Everything gets a little soggy. You might have even heard the raindrops on our Parab mics down there on the sideline. You can kind of hear it coming down hard as the Browns trail now by 13. Blitz coming on Weeden. Flares it out to Trent Richardson. Richardson with a head of steam.
Wow.
And taking guys with him, including Jamil McClain, for about the last 6 yards for a ride.
Now here's my question, Brad. You're a corner, okay? 230-pound Trent Richardson catches it with a 20-yard head of steam. What kind of effort are you going to make? Maybe not one.
Just throw a chicken wing out there and hope for the best.
Oh, man.
All the way out to the 43-yard line with a first down. 20-yard pass play. Weeden fakes the draw, loads, and comes back to the guy he faked it to, Trent Richardson, over the middle for a pickup of 4. And Weeden again has to pick himself up after the throw.
Now, obviously, we're in the fourth quarter, and there's some urgency. However, it's a 13-point ball game. You don't have to get completely out of your game plan. You still have to keep 33 involved, but you're going to throw the ball a little bit more vertically down the field.
Yep. Two-possession game with 13:45 left. Two eye backs as Marisic's in there, the up man in the eye. Weeden down the middle. Got his man to Little again, and he's got a first down at the 32-yard line.
That's the exact same play they ran off play action in the first half where they checked it down to Richardson. This time, they found the wide-open Little who's coming across. Play action, throwback. Little's wide open. Good throw, good catch.
And you know, they're playing, and we may have mentioned it earlier, playing without Muhammad Massaqua, one of their top receivers, so Little has had to come to the forefront.
Little's had to play big.
That's exactly right. Weeden 4 for 4 on this drive. 4 for 5. McClellan was getting pressure from the outside again.
Yeah, I actually like the way he stepped up into the pocket. He had pressure from both ends. And he looked like a veteran quarterback climbing the pocket, giving his offensive tackles a chance.
Again, they're getting in that area where you don't want to waste an opportunity, be it 3 or 7. You want a touchdown, obviously.
Yep. Yep.
With that, they'll keep it on the ground, but Richardson's going nowhere. McClellan again in on the play.
Yeah, they were bringing bodies here. They had 7, 8 players up in the box against the I formation. That McClellan's a pretty good football player.
Yes,
second
he is.
Year out of Marshall. Last year when Ray Lewis went down, McClellan stepped in and played really well.
Josh Gordon checks in as an extra wide receiver. Number 13, he'll go out to the top of your screen with Benjamin and Little near side. Third down, 11. Are the Ravens going to bring the house?
Here they
are. Weeden has to throw it in the dirt. It was supposed to be a screen pass to Richardson. And you want to let some of those guys come, but you don't want about 7 of them in your face.
They've got 7 up, and they're all coming. This is full-out blitz. Pollard's untouched. It's man-to-man in the secondary with no safety help whatsoever, where you're relying on pressure. Pollard came untouched. They brought more than Cleveland could block.
Phil Dawson's already hit a long one tonight, a 51. Can he hit a 50-yarder going the other way into the rain? They're trying to make it a 10-point game. He answers the question.
Money. He's money.
Is he ever?
Wow.
2 from 50 or longer tonight. Ray Lewis looks up at that scoreboard and sees that it's a 10-point game. 23-13, 12-10 to go. Some of the top quarterbacks in the NFL have had rocky starts in the first 3 weeks of the season. Drew Brees, 0-3. Tom Brady, Ben Roethlisberger, Peyton Manning, and Aaron Rodgers all at 1-2. And Mike, I had a friend of mine ask me today here in town, at what point are you going to ask Mike Mayock if Joe Flacco is an elite quarterback?
You're going to drop that in my lap.
Yeah, drop that right on you.
I think there are 7 franchise quarterbacks heading into the end of this year, and I think the 3 or 4 that are banging on that door are Joe Flacco, Matt Ryan, Cam Newton, and maybe Matthew Stafford if he can stay healthy.
Deontay Thompson from the goal line on the kick return. And he got out to about the 23-yard line. Here comes Joe Flacco, and there's his numbers on the night.
And Brad, to kind of take that one step further, my definition for a franchise quarterback is somebody can lead you to a Super Bowl, win the game, and be the guy.
Right.
You know, and I think in the modern Super Bowl era, you can point to Trent Dilfer with Baltimore, and maybe Tampa Bay, the year they were so dominant with Brad Johnson, as the two, quote, game managers. All the rest of them were dominant franchise quarterbacks. That's the guy you're looking for, and if you don't have him, you're not winning in this league.
It helps to have a guy like the guy that's running the ball right now, too, Ray Rice. Let's check in with Alex.
Hey, Brad. Well, Joe Flacco and I had that conversation on the field before this game tonight, whether or not he is an elite quarterback in this league. He says he doesn't necessarily compare himself to the Bradys and the Brees, but he says that he believes in himself and he believes in his ability. He says because of the way this team has been made up, his statistics, the offense hasn't necessarily favored him, but he believes in what he's able to bring to this team and his potential going forward in the future.
Let me tell you something, Alex. He does compare himself to those guys.
Here's a quick slant, and that's Anquan Boldin, his main target in this second half for a first down.
Bolden's had a big, big half, and Brad, to kind of finish that conversation, Alex brings up a lot of really good points. Flacco puts it on Bolden right here, and when I say he does compare himself, we had a conversation with him yesterday regarding him not signing a new contract yet and where he thinks he fits in this league. So, you know, he knows what Drew Brees just signed for, and he thinks he's a top three or four quarterback. And I don't blame him. You ought to think that.
Throwing that one intended for Pitta, and that could have been a dangerous one. And when we did talk to Joe Flacco, compared to this time last year, his demeanor in our meeting, you and I and Alex and the rest of the guys, you know, he's so at ease and he's so calm. And he just became a dad about 3 months ago. He's got a new son, Steven. And just the whole thing, the maturation process you've seen take place with this guy over the last couple of years. Ray Rice puts his head down and bangs his way out to the 48-yard line.
And now, see, he's the oldest of six kids.
Right.
And the conversation was kind of fun when you asked him about being a father because he just kind of launched into, well, we just had our first, and I'm thinking maybe 8 or 9.
Yeah.
I don't want him to look around the table and not have a bunch of siblings like I had. It was pretty cool.
I don't know if he's run that 8 or 9 past Dana, his wife, yet or not, but if he's hearing this for the first time, sorry, we had to be the bearer of those tidings. Third down and 3. Flacco pump fakes. Can't wait too long. He's got to get rid of this one. Good coverage by the Browns. Nobody open.
Yeah, a little frustration there. They were looking for Bolden on a choice route underneath, and there was really good coverage. Eventually, Juque Parker forced the throw away. What did he say about Haloti Ngata's son?
Or he said he's about the same age as his son, and he's already 25 pounds. It's the difference between a quarterback's kid and a nose tackle's kid. Sam Cook to kick. Remember, Cribbs was injured earlier in the ballgame, so different punt returner is Travis Benjamin.
Oh.
And flag flies in.
Yep. Yep. Anthony Allen.
Fair catch interference, kicking team, number 35, 15-yard penalty, first down Cleveland, timeout.
Cleveland trailing by 10. Elite quarterback, maybe, but not on that last drive. He's frustrated, but his team's up 10. Just over 10 minutes remaining in the fourth quarter. And the Browns have got it back after getting 3 out of their last drive, trailing by 10 with 10:01 left. Brandon Weeden, the rookie quarterback, keeping his team in the hunt. Play action. Up the middle, somebody got a hand on it, I think, on his throwing arm.
Yeah, and he's probably lucky because Webb was going to pick that off. And that was a variation of the play where Greg Little just ran and came all the way across the field. But what happens is you've got a corner sitting here waiting for it this time. Okay? Excuse me, the safety's waiting for it right there, Bernard Pollard. It's a good thing that ball got knocked down right there by Haloti Ngata or a piece. I think Pollard's still running.
Whedon's only officially been sacked once in 38 total dropbacks, but they've had a lot of pressure on him tonight. Here comes some more. And he threw it too far in front of Trent Richardson, incomplete.
You know, you talk about pressure, Brad. It's not always about sacks, like you just said. It's about getting pressure with varying looks. All three linebackers are coming. One breaks free. That's a big hit. Here's three-man pressure. Two of the three get to the quarterback for the one official sack. And again, now they're only bringing 4. This time, McClain comes through untouched, and they get constant pressure and constant hits on the rookie quarterback.
3 wideouts for Weeden on a big third down at 10. Here comes the pressure again. The pass is complete, but only to the 36-yard line.
That's what that pressure is designed to do. Third and long, force the quarterback to throw it hot and come up and tackle.
And the wily old veteran Ed Reed is the guy that does it.
They could care less if that pass was completed. You come up, you make the tackle, you force the punt.
Lardarius Webb goes back as the punt return man here off the foot of Reggie Hodges. high spiral. Fair catch called for and taken just outside the 15-yard line. 9-10 remaining in the ball game. Ravens clinging to a 10-point lead on their home field. Thursday night throwback. Remember this guy? Well, you should remember him. He's on our pregame show. But does he look a little bit like Ray Rice? Or does Ray Rice look a little bit like Marshall Faulk is what I meant to say.
I'm telling you, everything they do, the running style, the ability to catch the football, make people miss, the pass protection, the toughness, they remind me so much of each other, Brad, it's mind-boggling. I asked Marshall last night, I said, we're going to do a little package comparing you to Ray Rice. Do you mind that? He said, mind it. He said, he's one of my favorite players in the game today. That's a compliment.
Right now, right now he's on the sideline with Pierce in there. And he'll get the carry. Slipped a little bit. And then he's put down after a pickup of four. Clock ticking under the 9-minute mark. Ray Rice, 13 rushes and 8 catches, all in the first half.
Kind of interesting that both Ray Rice and Marshall Faulk were coached at the running back position by another running back with a similar style, who I used to love watching in Philadelphia. There he is, Wilbert Montgomery.
Behind, ready! Good! 20!
Play action. Flacco rolls to throw and completes it. And it's going to be a first down to Jacoby Jones. Pickup of 11. They'll move the sticks.
That was all about Jacoby Jones coming back to the football because there was good coverage on the edge. The veteran receiver coming all the way back. It's a deep comeback. Look at him running away from Patterson. Joe Flacco recognizes it. That play can't work unless Jacoby Jones hustles his tail back toward the sideline on a 45-degree angle.
Here is Ray Rice. Short gain. Unsolicited response to us asking him who he looks up to as far as football players
right
in the past.
Patting my game after Marshall Faulk because he's the most recent guy, you know, to leave the game who was dominant and, you know, running and catching. Hopefully I'll be, you know, remembered as, you know, great like Marshall Faulk.
That's pretty good.
Isn't that cool?
Yeah.
And I'm going to tell you one more statement. Marshall Faulk made the walk at Canton. And this kid, if he stays healthy and productive, will make that same walk someday.
Flacco trying to get away from the rush. Fujita ran him down with a shoestring tackle. Actually, no gain on the play.
Yeah, Fujita came all the way around, and Ray Rice got a block on him, but the pass didn't come out on time, obviously, and Fujita chased him down from behind.
Time is becoming an issue now if you're a Cleveland Browns fan. Down to 6:45 remaining, trailing by 10.
You've got to make a stop right here. It's 3rd and 9.
Yeah, this is where you need it.
Yeah, exactly. Two more possessions. Got to make a stop.
Flacco fires in and out of the hands of the intended receiver, Dawson. Screen did come up with a play, so they're going to get the football back.
Buster Screen is a competitive and feisty small corner. Liked him on tape in college. He only had one bad game I saw against Auburn. But outside of that one game in college, I really thought this kid competed, and they made a play when they needed to.
Sam Cook. Travis Benjamin should have a shot at this one. Fields it cleanly at the 14. He's got great speed if they can get him some blocks. Benjamin around the corner and down the sideline. Travis Benjamin, the rookie, knocked out of bounds by the punter. Or he might have taken it coast to coast. As it is, a 40-yard punt return, and boy, did they need that.
They're so young, and two of their young players just made plays. Buster Screen on the third down, and then Travis Benjamin on the punt return.
Benjamin, a 40-yard punt return, has the Browns in Ravens territory when we come back. Best starting field position for the Browns at the Ravens 46, courtesy of Travis Benjamin's punt return. On the bootleg, Weeden throws complete and got it to Josh Gordon, another rookie, and a pickup of 17 more.
Making a living off play action with deep crossing routes. Same thing again, crosser from behind.
Hold it, stop.
Another rookie. Keep in mind on offense, rookie quarterback, rookie tailback, rookie right tackle, two rookie receivers in Benjamin and Gordon. This is by far the youngest team in football.
Averaging about 25 and a half years of age, and if Weeden wasn't 28, it'd be a lot older. A lot younger, I should say. Weeden feeling kind of old on that one, as Nada got great heat on him again.
They wanted a double move to their tight end, Jordan Cameron. Heavy pressure, though. Again, Haloti Ngata. Just too quick and too strong. Nowhere near enough time on a double move.
Intentional grounding. Offense, number three. Quarterback was still in the pocket.
I'm not sure about this, though. I know he's in the pocket, but when the throw is impacted by a defender, let's see if Nada gets a piece of him prior to the ball. The ball's coming out, and I don't know if he takes a bunch of steam off of it because of the hit by Nada. And that's something a referee's got to decide. If he impacts the throw, it cannot be intentional grounding.
And I think we have another penalty, maybe.
Second and down.
Nope. He's going to walk it off.
Haloti Ngata is just, I don't believe you can block him one-on-one with any guard.
I thought they called unsportsmanlike conduct after that first penalty. Maybe not. They did, in fact. The ball's all the way back to the 44-yard line.
Well, who's the second call on?
I think it was on Pat Shurmur.
Was it on the bench?
Yeah. I think so. Well, that's one that they could have verbalized a little better to us.
That is huge.
It sure is. They had it at the 46-yard line. They're back at their own 44. Weeden reloads, fires complete, and Norwood's got it all the way down to the 34-yard line.
Wow.
So they got 22 back.
Second and 36, you get 22. That's pretty good, and I'm impressed with Brandon Weeden. He's hanging in the pocket. When he's got time to step up, look at him climb the pocket, buys him time. He's got clear vision. When he has clear vision and clean feet, he's really good.
Nine different receivers used tonight, too, Mike. It's pretty good. 5 minutes to play. There's his numbers. They need another one out of him here. Third down at 14. Ravens showing pressure. And here they come. Weeden stands in, throws long. Hands a little, it would have been a touchdown.
That was a seven-man blitz. Zero coverage, which means there's absolutely no help for anybody in the secondary. They're bringing seven. Look at the pickup by the tailback, Obanaya. Great job on Ray Lewis. Knocks him on his butt. The ball's thrown beautifully. Greg Little, you've got to catch the football. That's where you win or lose football games, right there.
That's five drop passes tonight. That hasn't helped Weeden. Evening. 52-yard attempt by Dawson. He's hit from 50 and 51. Trying to make it 3 points closer. This guy is unbelievable.
Yeah, man.
350-plus yard field goals by the 14-year veteran. And now it's 23-16, and we're back to a one-possession game with 4:33 to go.
Brad, you brought up a name earlier, and Terrell Suggs, T-Sizzle.
Yep.
And this is a Defensive Player of the Year who's on the PUP list, not eligible to come back and practice for at least the first 6 weeks of the season. Everybody around Baltimore likes to coin the phrase, you know, next man up. That's the popular thing to say. But when you lose 14 sacks and seven forced fumbles and the Defensive Player of the Year, there's no such thing. There's no other cat like him.
Right.
There's no next man up there. And as good a defense as this is, when you lose a guy like that, that can win one-on-one on a consistent basis, your defense loses a lot.
23-16. The Ravens have an eight-game winning streak against the Browns. The Browns have made it hard on them tonight. The 0-3 Cleveland Browns, but right now they know they're still in the thick of this football game with three timeouts remaining. Might be a little early to onside kick, I would think. but then I'm not the coach. Thompson is going to take a knee. And the Ravens will have it at the 20 against the Browns defense. After tonight, 10 more games on Thursday night for you next Thursday. Currently undefeated Cardinals swoop in to take on the St. Louis Rams. Surprise team right now. The Cardinals with wins over Seattle, New England, and Philadelphia. They meet Sam Bradford and the Rams Thursday night, next Thursday on NFL Network.
And I'm going to tell you right now, that Arizona defense, coordinated by Ray Horton, has playmakers at every level. Dockett, Calais Campbell at one level. How about a star in the making, the Washington kid from TCU at linebacker? I mean, they're really good. I'm looking forward to seeing them next week.
Only three undefeateds through three games so far. Rice has dropped for a loss. Loss of a couple. And Jamal Sheard again came off that corner.
You know what I think's cool about those three undefeated teams? They all play defense.
Yes.
Remember last year we were talking about New England and Green Bay and all the offensive firepower. Houston's got one of the best defenses in the league. How come wherever Mike Nolan goes, good defenses follow?
He's got the Falcons playing great defense, especially their two safeties, Moore and DQ.
Yep. And Matty Ryan's playing at a level that he's banging the door down saying, hey, I want to be in that group too.
I want to be in Mayock's elite. Here's a fading ball. What a catch. What a throw. And what a first down. Anquan Boldin's second half has been nothing short of sensational. His 33rd career 100-yard plus game.
In this league, you can't be afraid to throw the football up for grabs despite close coverage. Patterson's all over him, but the receiver has the advantage. Joe lays it in the bucket. Boldin uses that big body and strong hands, and they make a play.
Nine catches for 131 yards for Anquan Boldin.
Wow.
How about that?
Huge night. Huge night for Boldin. Keep in mind how strong he is. He's not a fast receiver. He never was. He's quicker than he is fast. In the slot, works off Patterson. You see him use his body. He pushes off a little bit. That's fine. He knows it's zone. Catch the football, break an ankle or two there on Buster's screen. Tight coverage. You snatch the ball behind you with great body control. Catch the low slant. And then finally, the pass he just caught. Joe drops it in over the shoulders. Really tight coverage by Patterson, but great concentration, and what a great evening for Anquan Boldin.
He had one catch in the first half. He had nine catches overall. He only had 10 coming into this game on the season. That was the biggest one so far in a group of big ones. Rice, and maybe a yard. Sheldon Brown undercut him to bring him down, but stays in bounds. Cleveland took one of their timeouts, try to preserve a possibility for their offense.
Hey, Greg Little makes a catch there. It's a tie ball game. And I talked to Pat Shurmur on the field. I talked to a bunch of their coaches. 341. And they think they're really close with these young kids. You know, they're a play or two. They lost to Philly 17-16.
Right.
You know, they've played some teams tough. They lost to a good Cincinnati team, 34-27. They're a play or two away from winning games. And that's highly frustrating.
One of the few times tonight that the Ravens have huddled. With 3:41 remaining.
Yeah, the clock is your friend now.
Yep.
Take your time.
Cleveland's only got one timeout remaining, plus the two-minute warning. They'd love to come up with a turnover here. Rice cuts it outside. Ray Rice down the sideline and all the way to the 32-yard line.
Oh, boy. You know, we talk about Marshall Faulk. Flag is down. Yep. Mike Lohr's having a conversation with the ref, and he's very animated right now. He's already had two or three penalties tonight, I believe.
Offense, number 74, 10-yard penalty, replay second down.
He better watch himself or he's going to get thrown out of the game.
Yep.
Really good job by Vonte Leach pulling him away from the ref. He was screaming, I didn't hold. Here he is right there. Let's see what it looks like. This is a weak side zone play. At this point, there's the hold, even though it was quick. On Kaluka Maeva and probably wasn't a significant hold, but they saw it. Whenever you're reaching outside the framework of your body, be careful, big boy. Be careful. Good job, Vonte Leach.
Oh!
Really good job.
Pierce comes back in to the Raven backfield now. Second down and 19. That really hurt him, but Pierce might get it all back. Blast into the secondary, and he picks up 16.
Marshall Yanda, the right guard, pulled and got to the second level. It was gorgeous. Love seeing it. Watch Yanda, the right guard. He's going to pull and get up to the second level. Pierce is going to follow that block. Pitta and Yanda do a great job forcing the hole open. The rookie from Temple.
Had over,
field. Go ahead, Brad.
Had over 3,500 yards in his career with Temple and 53 touchdowns.
Yep.
Don't forget next week. Right now the Cardinals are unbeaten going into Bradford territory and the Rams. And then the 11th, it's the Steelers and the Titans. Seattle off to a surprising start. They take on San Francisco.
Both
2-1 right now. Vikings, you mentioned, 2-1 against Tampa Bay. We'll see Andrew Luck on the 8th. The Bills and the Dolphins on the 15th. Falcons right now unbeaten. Saints need some wins between now and November 29th. And then we wrap it up with those final two games. A chance to see Peyton Manning in action and Michael Vick and company. Every Thursday, so we hope you're with us.
Third and three. Joe's changing the play at the line of scrimmage.
And he's going to throw for it. Pump fakes and goes deep down the sideline. Broken up at the last moment by Sheldon Brown and a flag.
Yeah, this is going to be either a pass interference or on one, either Tandon Doss or Buster Screen.
There was a flag on the near side of the field,
yeah,
too.
That's what I mean. That's the one.
Yeah.
Prior to the pass, holding defense number 22.
Yep.
5-yard penalty, automatic, first down.
Yeah, that was completely away from the throw. But Buster Screen, number 22, on the down here at the bottom, pulls him down as he's going down.
Takes a handful of jersey.
And, you know, let me go back to that play, though. I love the fact that third and three, Joe Flacco checked out, took control of the offense, said, I got one-on-one at the top, and I'm going out there. In this league, big-time quarterbacks make those kind of decisions and throws under pressure.
Remember, the Browns have used all their timeouts. So as long as the Ravens keep moving it down the field, a two-minute warning will be the only stop they can get. That's Usama Young, the safety, who's limping over there on the Browns sideline.
Yeah, Raven Trone is in the game for him.
Ray Rice with both hands around the football. Gets it near the 40. And the clock will wind its way down. Under 3 minutes. Browns desperate for a turnover here of some sort, or they might not get it back in the hands of Trent Richardson and their offense.
Yeah, that penalty really hurt them.
Yeah.
You know, away from the ball, you make a stop on third down, and you give up a penalty like that. All these little things add up to a loss. That's what happens with young teams.
With a two tight end set, Leach in there as well. It's Rice right behind his fullback for a yard, maybe a little bit more. Billy Wynn in on the tackle. And that should just about take it down to the two-minute warning, which is the only stoppage the Browns have left.
Correct. Greg Little made a couple of spectacular catches tonight, but could not come up with the most important throw of the evening. And that's kind of been the story of his career, both at North Carolina and in the NFL. Spectacular big body that runs fast and makes an occasional catch, but just not consistent enough to make all the catches he needs to.
Big third down coming up for the Ravens when we come back following the two-minute warning. And by Pizza Hut's Big Dinner Box, all your favorites in one epic box. Pizza Hut, make it great. Speaking of great, Rich Eisen.
Why, thank you, Brad. We're getting set for another entertaining, informative post-game show. Who will be the star of the game on the set? That is a mystery that will be solved in about 2 minutes.
All right. At the two-minute mark, third down and 7 for the Ravens.
Ready!
Leading by 7.
Ready!
Flacco rolls. He's going to keep it. Get what he can. Goes down after a pickup of 2.
Good job staying in bounds, number one. Jabal Sheard chases him down from behind, but kept the clock rolling by staying in bounds. And now a decision has to be made. I think you got to punt it. I'm not taking a shot with a long field goal and a low trajectory and have a chance to get it blocked.
That's going
to
be the call, Mike.
Yeah.
Remember, Justin Tucker missed one wide right earlier.
Yep.
And had a controversial one against New England. So they're going to try to pin the Browns down inside the 10 here.
Yeah, pooch it down there and play some defense.
Charge timeout, Baltimore. 30-second timeout.
I think Jerry Rosberg, the special teams coach, probably want to have a conversation out there with his guys.
Well, they ran it all the way down to the 1:13 mark before calling the timeout.
That's Jerry Rosberg right in the middle there. Does a great job with their special teams. And see Harbaugh next to him?
Yep. Former special teams guy knows he's got to be in there as well.
And I'm a big advocate that special teams coaches should be given more consideration for head coaching jobs. They're the only other guy besides the head coach that have their fingers on all 53 players. They're with the offense, they're with the defense. You know, there's some guys throughout the league that I think ought to be special teams coach. Excuse me, be head coaches. That's a pretty good representation there. However, the old school guys also coached the position back in the day. Romeo Crennel was one of my special teams coaches, but Richie Bisaccia from San Diego, Joe DeCamillis, there are several special teams coaches qualified to be head coaches in this league.
Cook punts this one to the corner, goes out of bounds. It'll just be a matter of where they're going to spot this.
Yep.
It's going to be around the 10, I think. In fact, it's right at the 10. So Brandon Weeden, here you go. We said to him, what was your first NFL moment? He said, walking on the field at Lambeau. And I went, wow, I'm at Lambeau Field. Guess what? You're at M&T Bank Stadium right now. A touchdown behind the Baltimore Ravens, who've been teeing off on you all night. You only have to go 90 yards to tie it up with no timeouts.
Yeah, by the way, no timeouts. A bunch of young rookies around you. And this is where you've got to get the ball vertically down the field. Obviously, your receivers have to be aware of getting out of bounds. This is a gut check for a young quarterback.
Norwood, Gordon, and Little are the wideouts for Brandon in the shotgun. 90 yards away from a tie game. Here comes the pressure again. Throws short over the middle. But running with it is Benjamin Watson. And Ben Watson has got 13 yards and gets out of bounds.
Yeah, they had double A-gap pressure showed right there, which is the A-gap is the gap on either side of the center. And Ray Lewis dropped out. They still rushed five, and a good job by Weeden getting rid of the football.
59 seconds remaining. No timeouts for the Browns. Extra rusher comes late. The throw is complete. No, it's not in and out of the hands of Norwood. He had it, and then he tried to scrape it off Webb's body to keep it alive, and it's incomplete.
This kid, this quarterback, is hung in there all day long, and Norwood slipped kind of and I think lost concentration. That ball's still alive.
Yeah, it was.
It's kicking around on their legs and everything. Look at this. Look at the ball. Up in the air. It's still in the air. He kicks it. It's on the leg. This kid, Weeden's hung in there, made some throws. This is not too big an arena for him.
Throws. Got a man wide open, and Norwood gets everything he can. Almost tried to cut it back to the inside.
He almost popped out the other side.
He did.
All right, they got two short crossing routes, picked up an awful lot of yardage. Norwood's in the slot. They're going to let any of those short routes go, but what happened was number 59 Ellerby got caught on the inside route. He lost his spacing. And as soon as you lose, forget the inside route. Let the clock keep running. You can't let them get out of bounds like that.
At midfield with 45 seconds to go. Blitz on Weeden. Can't take a sack here. Throws it back across his body. And he got it to Watson. First down, pickup of 17.
And Watson
clock running down to 30.
Watson was his hot receiver. He didn't take it and found a way to still make a play.
25 seconds, no timeouts. And now they spike it to stop the clock with 23.
I really don't care how this thing ends up. Brandon Weeden, in my opinion, has stepped up, made throws. Greg Little drops a touchdown pass. They start on their own 10. They're already down at the 33-yard line. The kid is hanging in there. Look at, there's the hot route. Now, Watson, we're on scramble rules. Go help your quarterback. Show your numbers to him. Nice job.
320 yards passing for Brandon Weeden. He's worked his team down to the 33-yard line with no timeouts. Down seven. Weeden waits, points, throws deep. Tipped and broken up. Norwood, the intended receiver.
That was almost a touchdown. Ed Reed was looking to jump little, gets back in late, and just gets a piece of it.
Wow.
Yeah, Reed was looking to make a pick on the other side of the field off little and just got back in time. He got a fingertip on that.
Browns took over at their own 10 with 1:05 left and no timeouts. This is the seventh play of the drive. Time for a couple more plays and what looks like it's going to be a dramatic finish. Weeden, play action, throws, got a man, tipped, incomplete. And ironically enough, what this game is going to come down to is a Hail Mary, much like Seattle and Green Bay and the fiasco that got our regular officials back in the football game.
My, oh my.
There may be time for a quick pass to get the 10 and get out of bounds, but there's 10 seconds remaining.
Yeah, you've got an opportunity to make two plays here if you'd like to. However, the first play's got to be on the sidelines if you're going to go for two.
Baltimore is going to take a timeout.
Second charge timeout. Baltimore, the second timeout.
Good idea. They can get their heads together. The Ed Reeds and the Ray Lewis. Give themselves a quick breather.
And I think they're a little tired. This kind of pace, you're rushing the quarterback every snap. I think it makes some sense. Take your time. Let your guys get ready to go again. Give Nada a blow.
Last week, a lot of barn burners. We're coming down to the last 10 seconds here in a game that very few people gave the Cleveland Browns any hope of winning. They trail by seven with 10 seconds left. There's Greg Little, who's made some big plays, and he's let several go through his fingers. Does he have one more big play in him, or does Brandon Weeden, who has set a new career high in this, his young rookie season, and it's only week four. Joe Flacco can barely look.
Three wide receivers down on the bottom.
Here's the ball game on fourth down. Weeden loads, gonna go to the end zone. Same spot, tipped, incomplete. And it's over. 2 seconds remaining, but in the very same spot that Green Bay and Seattle decided a game, this one's gonna be decided for the home team.
Hold on, hold on.
Personal foul. Unnecessary roughness. Defense number 99.
Whoa.
It's a 15-yard penalty. Automatic. First down.
It's not over.
Paul Kruger with a personal foul. And it was stupid. He just pushed Joe Thomas late. And I think is what I saw. Plays over right there. Turns around and pushes him up there. Now Joe gets... Did they give an Emmy? Emmy's out the other night. Did I hear Emmy Awards for the... Because, you know, Joe gets an Emmy for that, but Kruger can't make that move in that situation. You kidding me?
One play left, barring a defensive penalty.
Yeah, now your playbook's open.
The Browns with one last shot, and now the Ravens are going to take their last timeout.
Third and final, timeout, Baltimore. A 30-second timeout.
I think the two guys they have to be looking at are Josh Gordon, who's 6'3 and jumps out of the gym, and Jordan Cameron, the tight end. I watched Cameron on the field before the game. He's 6'5, jumps like a gazelle.
Here was the end of the play before the personal foul as Williams knocked it away, and that was the guy they were aiming it at, the guy you're just talking about.
Yeah. See how high Cameron gets up there at 6'5. And by the way, 13 Gordon's there also. Kruger gets pushed a little bit, turns around. You can't get in his face like that. That's as bad a penalty as you can take at this point in the game. You can't do that.
a penalty. One snap left. Brandon Weeden throws back of the end zone too far. Man. Ravens win. Nine straight victories for Baltimore over Cleveland. But the Browns gave them everything they could handle and then some.
As complimentary as I've been about Brandon Weeden, you can't throw this ball out of the back of the end zone. This is a bad throw. This is an inaccurate throw. You got to give somebody a chance to catch the football. And I know you got hit, but the worst thing you can do, here comes Kruger. And I know that affects the throw, but the ball's got to land somewhere in the end zone. It can't be 6 yards beyond it. Can't happen.
The last chance for the Browns right there. Final score, Ravens 23, the Browns 16. It's going to do it for Mike and Alex and I. We'll be back in a minute. Joe Flacco will be on the set with Rich and the guys. Highlights, analysis, interviews, and press conferences. We'll be back in a minute with the McDonald's postgame show.